hire, you need to post your job on all the top job sites. And now you can with ZipRecruiter.com. You can post your job to 50-plus job sites, including social networks like Facebook and Twitter, all with a single click. Find candidates in any industry nationwide. Just post once and watch your qualified candidates roll in to ZipRecruiter's easy-to-use interface. And with ZipRecruiter's premium traffic boost, you can get up to 3 times more candidates. Quickly screen applicants, rate them, and hire the right person fast. Find out why ZipRecruiter has been used by over 200,000 businesses. Right now, our listeners can try ZipRecruiter for free. Plus, get 30% off your first traffic boost by going to ZipRecruiter.com/info. That's ZipRecruiter.com/info. One more time, to try it for free, go to ZipRecruiter.com/info.
While they may be healthy to eat, flowers also come with their own warning labels. What experts say you need to know before you grow and eat. That's coming up on This Land of Ours.
Why does Daddy spend so much time caring for the land, Mom?
When he's taking care of the land, he's really taking care of us.
How?
He wants us to have clean water to drink, fresh air to breathe, wildlife to enjoy, and he wants to leave this land better than he found it.
Sounds like Daddy loves us a lot.
He sure does.
Conservation, there's something in it for you. Call or visit your local USDA service center. Brought to you by the Natural Resources Conservation Service.
Did you know your checkoff is sharing the benefits of beef with millennials through social media? Did you know your beef checkoff helped get 6 extra lean cuts certified as heart healthy by the American Heart Association? Did you know your checkoff is helping us set new U.S. beef export records? While you manage your operation, your beef checkoff is working hard to keep beef top of mind with consumers here and around the world. Get to know your checkoff and start sharing the facts at mybeefcheckoff.com. Funded by the Beef Checkoff.
If you're growing edible flowers and consuming them, there are some precautions to consider. Cindy Lauderdale of North Carolina Cooperative Extension says, for example, not all species within a family of flowers is edible. So she says, do your research via books or on the internet before deciding to eat a flower. Also,
if you want to eat flowers, growing your own organically without any chemicals so you know that they're safe.
In addition, animal manure used in compost or fertilizer should not be used in edible flower beds to avoid exposure to viral or fungal pathogens. One other thing
is, if you're going to start into eating edible flowers, is to just try one at a time and see how your system does, because you may react differently than somebody else.
I'm Kathy Isom, Southeast AgNet.
A lot of people think I'm superstitious. I never step on cracks. I never keep black cats on the ranch. I never open umbrellas indoors, not even in the barn. And I never let a young calf go unvaccinated. Because young calves are up against a whole lot more than you think. And I'm not just talking about bad luck, but stuff that even their mama's milk can't protect them from in the long run. Like BVD type 1B, the most common subtype of BVD in infected calves. That's why I vaccinate them with Pyramid 5 Plus Pre-Sponse SQ. It's the only approved combination vaccine that protects calves from BVD type 1B respiratory disease for at least 217 days. Plus, its viral and bacterial protection shields the unluckiest of calves. Even my doomed number 13 calf. Talk with your Boehringer Ingelheim VetMedica Inc. representative today. Learn more at bi-vetmedica.com/cattle.
Get it for less at the DIY Home Center Outlet. Get top quality real wood cabinets the same or less than the big box stores are selling the cheap stuff. And that's not all. Drywall screws big box stores are $6.47 a pound. At DIY, only $4.99. Plus, DIY has the largest selection of mobile home parts and accessories anywhere. From carpet to doors, get the DIY supplies you need for less. The DIY Home Center Outlet. We are your building material closeout store. 2191 Northwest 10th Street, just 2 miles east of I-75.
Good credits, bad credits. It's none of our business because we're not an auto dealer. We're not a bank. We're not your mother. We're OcalaForSale.com, Marion County's marketplace for cars, trucks, and SUVs. We've got thousands of sellers standing by to take your call. No middleman. But hurry, don't walk, don't run. Just sit down and log on to OcalaForSale.com.
Prices and inventory change daily. Offer does not include dealer upcharge. Undercutting, rust proofing, factory surcharge, or delivery fee. See website for details.
WOCA 1370 WOCA.
about to hear is the fusion of entertainment and enlightenment. This is the Glenn Beck Program.
Welcome to the program. Today is a very interesting day. It is. It started this morning at about 6 o'clock, receiving an email from Grover Norquist's office saying, "Oh no, I no, we weren't saying that we weren't going to be on the TV show tonight."
Because if you missed it, you got an email during the show last night saying.
Yes. We're not going to be on your show.
We're not going to be on your show.
And I want to read the email. I want to read the email chain to you because it's really almost psychotic. Somebody in his office is really screwed up because it's bizarre. It is the most bizarre series of, we've never had this problem setting up a guest before. Never. This has been going on for like 2 weeks. And first the idea was that Grover Norquist, I absolutely want to answer these charges. Okay. So I offered him an hour. Well, no. Now, wait a minute. My wife has to be there. We have to have some ground rules.
His wife has to be there?
Yeah. He wanted his wife there because his wife is part of this and she's being picked on. And I said, we haven't mentioned your wife. Your wife has nothing to do with this. Yeah, well, others have. Well, we haven't. We're just talking about the facts of what you've done. That's all I want to know about. I don't care. I mean, I don't want to bring your wife. If you won't want your wife involved, why would you insist that your wife is brought on to this topic? Doesn't make any sense. So we said, no, it's a one-on-one with you. Okay. And then he said, well, I can't make it on that Tuesday. Okay. And you're not going to play the documentary, right? Yes, we're going to do the expose on you. We're going to do that Monday. That's why we want you on Tuesday. Well, I can't make it on Tuesday. Okay. What day can you make it? I can make it on Thursday. Okay. Well, then we'll play the expose on Wednesday.
And then he gets to rebut it on Thursday. That's a great offer.
Okay.
So if you're innocent, who wouldn't snap that up?
Okay.
Seriously.
All right. So here's what, let me just give you the last couple. Let's see. John is the person in his office, and this is between him and my producer, Tiffany. Hey, John, never heard back from you whether or not Grover is going to join us on Thursday. You need to let us know one way or another. Hi, Tiffany. Can you be specific on what you want Grover to do? 1 hour on air to examine the concerns and attacks.
We were thinking about dancing, maybe a little soft shoe.
I know. This is what I understand. as I look at the emails, I hear, one, you want 1 hour on air to examine the concerns and attacks from the Wednesday evening Beck TV show. Two, Grover and Beck will air for a full hour without additional guests. If you wish to have other guests, Grover can arrange for someone to join. Is the above correct? We will do this at your DC TV studio between these times. Okay. That's what we had. Tiffany says, yes, I just want to confirm the interview time is between this, the conversation between Glenn and Grover. We can arrange the transportation to our DC bureau if needed. Let me know if you need anything else. Then we get this email. Now, this I'm handed during the show.
I have that segment of the show if you want to.
Oh, you do?
Yeah.
Yeah, go ahead.
Dude.
So I already lay out 20 minutes of the chalkboard, and it's really quite damning. And then I get this email.
We just received an email. No conservative should have to pay Glenn Beck to hear a grown-up response to Frank Gaffney's nonsense. 2 weeks ago, March 11th, Glenn had Frank Gaffney on his radio show for a lengthy interview in front of an audience of 7 million Americans. It's actually 8.
It's actually 10.
uncritically accepting Gaffney's 10 to 15-year-old nonsense, Glenn kept saying over and over, Grover was a dangerous and bad man. On the free public airwaves in front of 7 million people, 8,
10.
Glenn repeated Gaffney's long discredited nonsense over the course of several shows, never checking anything. Absolutely untrue. Never reaching out to us for a reality check. Absolutely untrue. And then, after repeating stuff from Gaffney over and over the public airwaves, you invite Grover to a paid subscription-only show with a different, much smaller audience. If you are now interested in the facts that dozens of reporters and most conservative leaders already know, the best way would to perceive to hash through Gaffney's attacks in front of the audience, where Glenn gave Gaffney plenty of time to present them. If you're serious about doing fact-checking of this material, contact me in a time to find a time to do something on the radio show, the same venue where Gaffney told his conspiracy theory.
Now that sounds like an absolute
if you're serious about fact-checking, contact me to find out a time to do something on the radio.
Yeah. That sounds like he backed out of the show, right?
All right, yes, that is backing out, of the show. I'm not doing the TV show because nobody should have to pay for it.
And it's too little.
And it's too little.
Too little.
It's too little. Okay. So we wrote back. Let's see. We wrote back. That's fine. Glenn will make the entire show free tomorrow so everyone who doesn't get us on cable could watch it. Are you still backing out? Let us know. We dedicated a full show to this. Okay? This morning at 6:39 a.m., after I've flown new guests in, we've completely changed the show. I posted on Facebook last night what he had said, and then I posted, I'm actually kind of glad, because after the show and after he canceled, I said, I want to look at all the boards that he's on. Because not only is he on the board of directors of the NRA, he is also on the board of the American Conservative Union. You know, the group that fact-checked him. The Center for National Interest. Parental Rights Organization. Doesn't that sound like the guy you want? The Hispanic Leadership Fund. The American Society for Competitiveness. The American Spectator. And GOP Proud. Now, he was also on the board of directors of CPAC, which when we start piecing this stuff together, I'm telling you, we're at the beginning of a Van Jones thing. This guy, I'm convinced, is the Muslim Brotherhood's Tides Foundation. This guy, whether he knows it or not, is just a laundry service. He is laundering people like nobody's business. And so I said, after we did the show last night, I said, you know what? Fly a bunch of people in. I want to talk about all the people that he has placed on boards, like boards of like Seagram's. He has placed people on as board of directors all over. And this is exactly what the Muslim Brotherhood Project is all about. And I think he's part of it. Knowingly or unknowingly, that's what he's doing. And Karl Rove, I think, is part of it. Now, I don't know how much Karl Rove knows, but Karl Rove gave $26 million out of Crossroads. So if you gave money to
Grover Norquist?
To Grover Norquist. So if you gave money to Crossroads, $26.4 million in 2012 went to Grover Norquist.
In what foundation?
His, let's see here, his American Tax Reform.
26 okay, so that, million.
That's what's his. Paying. He and the Koch brothers are pretty much paying for everything he does there. The question, the institute that he put together that is in wild question is the Islamic Institute. Now, the only reason why the American tax reform is in question is because of all of that money coming from Crossroads and Karl Rove. And Karl Rove knows who he has placed. Grover Norquist has placed Alamudi, a guy who is now in prison on terror charges, next to the president, next to Karl Rove, next to Dick Cheney, placed him next to Bill Clinton, Hillary Clinton. I mean, this guy took a guy who was a terrorist and arranged meetings for them. Sami Alarian, one of the reasons why he got off is because he was talking to the jury and he was showing these picture after picture after picture after picture. How could I possibly be with all of these guys if I'm such a danger? Grover Norquist. Grover Norquist. He's laundering people.
When you saw this laid out last night, it really reminded me of your heyday at Fox when you were laying out all the evidence against Van Jones and the Tides Foundation. It's
the same thing.
At least that good, if not better.
Thank you. That's what's happening.
Yeah.
This is the right Tides Foundation.
Here's what
I think Grover thinks he's doing with the Islamic Institute. Just like, these are his words. I don't know where they are, but I think I read these in his words this morning, that one of his reasons for doing it is, I don't know where it is, but I think it's from him. One of the reasons why he did this and started this Islamic Institute was because the Jews had been co-opted by the Democrats. And there's a lot of money there, and there's a lot of power there, et cetera, et cetera. So let's get in on the ground floor of the Muslims. And let's have the GOP be the Muslim people. So the Democrats can have the Jews, we'll have the Muslims.
What a great idea.
What a great idea, huh?
Huh?
Just a fantastic idea.
Well, when you put it that way, it sounds totally logical.
Yes, it does. Now, this is in 1994, 98, but yeah. Still, we know who these guys are. They're chanting death to America. Who loves Hezbollah? Who loves Hamas? Oh, we do, we do. And if you don't know, if you're Grover Norquist and you're getting money from Qatar, the Wahhabist in Saudi Arabia, you're getting money from really, really dark places, and you don't pay attention to it. I mean, you have a guy who's now sitting in prison on terror charges. You have another guy who was just deported by the Obama administration. Imagine being so bad that you're deported by the Obama administration. That doesn't happen. You're a Muslim terrorist and you've been deported? How bad do you have to be that guy? One of these guys is one of the founders, co-founders with Grover of his Islamic Institute. The other guy gave him, the guy who's sitting in prison, gave him two checks of $10,000 each as the seed money to start the Islamic Institute. I don't know, that's a problem. So now this morning, we get an email from Grover's office. Tiffany, no, I was arguing for having Grover do the radio show over than TV because Gaffney lied to the radio audience. Grover wants to do the TV show as planned. It remains on his schedule. And Glenn and Grover will go for the hour over last night's TV show. Quite honestly, I don't know if it's going to last an hour. It will last an hour if he answers the questions. If he tries to make this about Frank Gaffney, about his wife, about anything else, it's over. Because I'm not going to sit here and have somebody grandstand, waste your time. I'm not going to have anybody play the game that politicians always play. If he wants to answer the questions, great. If not, I've flown people in and I have another show all planned and I'm not going to waste your time.
And the reason you have another show planned is because he backed
because
out of it last night.
He canceled last night.
Email. Yeah.
He canceled last night. So tonight's show is free. I'm going to make that one concession to him. You don't have to go behind the paywall. It is free. You can watch it. But I will tell you this. We had a conversation last night. All he's done is piss me off. Because he has been the biggest pain in the ass. And I'm sorry, but his people have been, I believe, unprofessional. We have not been dealt with this way by anybody else. And you know, Pat, I have our staff bend over backwards.
Oh,
we
yeah.
never sandbag yeah. anybody. We always tell them exactly where we stand.
And in this case, we've said it for 3 weeks.
Yeah, we are not. We don't play games like that. We do not play gotcha.
He knows what the deal
anything
is.
Else. Yes, he does. And quite honestly, once I saw that Karl Rove and Crossroads gave $26 million to Grover, I asked myself this question this morning. I just read a bunch of stories from conservatives last week that said the grand architect of the GOP isn't usually this stupid. Why would Karl Rove come on to O'Reilly last week and pick a fight and bring up that Glenn Beck is leaving the GOP and try to smear me on TV? Why? As the other conservative said, it was over. It wasn't a big deal. It had already run its course. It was over. Why at the tail end of that, as it was all dying out, would you go back on O'Reilly and say that for 7 minutes? You know that's just going to heat things up. You let it go away. And I wondered, if I'm the guy who wrote Grover Norquist a check for $26 million out of my PAC, and I'm the guy who Grover called and said, hey, I need to get some pictures with President Bush and Alamudi. I need to get some pictures with some of these guys who I'm working with, Khalid Safouri or Sami Alarian, and I need to have them take some pictures with the officials in Washington. Can you get that done? I probably would want to destroy Glenn Beck as well. I'd probably want to smear him as well. I'd probably want him to fight two fronts instead of one. You know, Custer, a GOP operative, told me this one time. Glenn, you know what your problem is? No. You're Custer. What does that mean? Custer could have won if he would have convinced the Indians to come over the hill one at a time. Now, this same GOP operative is involved with Karl Rove. Isn't it interesting that Karl Rove decides to open up another front while I have Grover Norquist going as well? And seemingly to his detriment. I'm sure it's just a coincidence, because I don't want to engage in conspiracy theories, but I'm sure it's just a coincidence. The reason why I bring it up is because we're now fighting a battle on two fronts, and I believe they are connected. I believe that Karl Rove and Grover Norquist are joined at the hip, and there's something very bad here. As we were talking yesterday, or this morning, and I want to get into this after the break, this explains why we play pussyfoot with Islam and the Muslim Brotherhood. This explains everything. We'll get into it a little bit more in just a second. Our sponsor this half hour is Liberty Safe. Liberty has this new cool video out right now where they test their products. You've seen them drop safes from a crane or blow them up with dynamite. Well, they've done some practical testing too, like what the average thief might do. LibertySafe.com, they have a new video that shows how the top three brands in the $500 and $600 range perform when two really big guys try to pry them open. The Made in USA Liberty Revolution safe, safe made in Mexico, and one built in China. Unbelievably, they were able to pry both import safes open in less than a minute, and one of them is open in 21 seconds. The Liberty, they could not get in. It is amazing how much safer Liberty Safe really is. 10 times stronger. Made in the USA, Liberty Safe. Check out the video today and check out their safes at LibertySafe.com.
Glenn Beck.
The Blaze Radio Network.
All loans subject to OnDeck score approval must be in business at least 1 year to apply.
If you're a small business owner in need of financing and don't have the time or the patience for your bank's lending process, speak with OnDeck, the small business resource that says yes a lot more and a lot faster. Just ask Steve Hickson.
Our accounting firm was in need of working capital. OnDeck was terrific and came through with the funding we needed within 24 hours. It was, without a doubt, the simplest loan process I have ever experienced.
At OnDeck, we're 100% focused on small business loans only, and we evaluate businesses based on actual performance, not just your personal credit. Our easy application process could take just minutes, and you could receive funding in as little as one business day. Less paperwork, no obligations, and a decision in minutes. OnDeck has an A+ Better Business Bureau rating and is publicly listed on the New York Stock Exchange. We provided over $2 billion in funding to businesses just like yours. So if you're a small business owner who needs business financing, go to OnDeckLending.com or call 800-294-2215. That's 800-294-2215.
Logano is set to pull double duty in Martinsville. I'm Kyle Rickey. That story next on NASCAR Today, midday.
MRN.com is your home for online streaming of NASCAR races and original MRN Motorsports programming. Listen at home or on the road to NASCAR Sprint Cup Series practices and qualifying, Sprint Cup, Xfinity, and Camping World Truck Series races, plus exclusive original online-only programs such as MRN Motorsports Monday, Winged Nation, the Straight Line, NASCAR Coast to Coast, Fast Food, and Throwback Tuesday. Streaming across the country and around the world on MRN.com.
There's a lot on the line here, and we'll keep digging.
Winning races is what it's all about.
You know, the pressure is definitely on.
Every moment matters.
The intensity ratchets up.
You need to get the checkered flag.
Man, I just took the 43 car to victory lane at Daytona.
It's pretty unbelievable.
I can't explain it. It's a dream.
What I'm not going to do is back down. I'm not here to lose. I'm here to win.
Where else does a regular season win mean so much? Nowhere but NASCAR.
It was the greatest single day of my life.
Daytona 500 winner Joey Logano will race in both the NASCAR Camping World Truck Series race on Saturday and the NASCAR Sprint Cup Series race on Sunday at the Martinsville Speedway in Virginia. He hopes that Saturday's 250-lap truck race will give him an advantage on Sunday.
I think I'm running the truck race, so I think that could help me a little bit because I've never run anything but a Sprint Cup car there before. So with the lessened horsepower this year in the Cup cars, it should bring it more like a truck. So I'll run the truck race to kind of help me out there. I think that would be a good thing.
David Gilliland and Travis Quappel will also be running both races. And veteran crew chief Slugger Labby has been suspended by NASCAR for the next three Sprint Cup races and fined $50,000 for an improperly installed truck trailing arm mounting bracket and bolt last week in California. Learn more at MRN.com. I'm Kyle Rickey. This is NASCAR Today Midday on the Motor Racing Network.
It's going to be a very, very interesting day. At theblaze.com/TV, it will all be free tonight. You'll be able to watch tonight's episode with Grover Norquist. I urge you to do that. Might be hard to follow if you didn't see last night's show, but that's on demand. And tomorrow night's show is a 2 hours special at 8 p.m. on the Muslim Brotherhood. It's called The Project, and it's done by For the Record, our investigative news department. For the Record, that's tomorrow night, 8 p.m. You don't want to miss it. This is really important in regards to national security and who the GOP is deeply in bed with. More in a minute.
The Glenn Beck Program.
The Blaze Radio Network.
This is a Fox News alert. I'm Lillian Wu. The FBI assisting in the crash of the German Wings Airbus, which a co-pilot apparently intentionally flew into the French Alps. The head of Lufthansa, which owns German Wings, says he's shocked and horrified.
There has never been the slightest restriction, any doubt cast on his competence and his skills.
Voice of a translator for CEO Carsten Spohr, who says that Andreas Lubitz passed every test in check. We're also learning the 28-year-old had trained at a flight center in a suburb of Phoenix, Arizona. A Florida community reeling from a shooting which left two brothers dead.
A 6-year-old boy from Pasco County, Florida, north of Tampa, is dead after being shot by his 13-year-old big brother over what began as an argument over dinner.
This is tough on us as law enforcement. This is tough on the community and for the friends.
Pasco's Sheriff Chris Nocco. The 13-year-old also shot and wounded his bigger brother before taking his own life.
Fox Radio's Evan Brown, Fox News. We report, you decide.
I'm Lex Friedman. I run my own business, so I know from experience, hiring new employees can be tough. Posting your job in one place isn't enough to find quality candidates. If you want to find the perfect hire, you need to post your job on all the top job sites. And now you can, with ZipRecruiter.com. You can post your job to 50-plus job sites, including social networks like Facebook and Twitter, all with a single click. Find candidates in any industry nationwide. Just post once and watch your qualified candidates roll in to ZipRecruiter's easy-to-use interface. And with ZipRecruiter's premium traffic boost, you can get up to 3 times more candidates. Quickly screen applicants, rate them, and hire the right person fast. Find out why ZipRecruiter has been used by over 200,000 businesses. Right now, our listeners can try ZipRecruiter for free. Plus, get 30% off your first traffic boost by going to ZipRecruiter.com/info. That's ZipRecruiter.com/info. One more time. To try it for free, go to ZipRecruiter.com/info.
Pay your taxes, eat your vegetables, watch your weight, mow the lawn, clean the house. We all have stuff we don't want to do. Isn't it about time you did something you wanted to do? Like getting your pilot's license? At Ocala Aviation, they make it fun and easy, and you can start by taking one of their Discovery flights. For only $99, you get to go up in the airplane with an FAA-certified flight instructor and actually fly the plane yourself. It's a perfect way to see if flying is for you. And once you get that ultimate feeling of freedom, Ocala Aviation can train you to get your pilot's license. Ocala Aviation also offers commercial flight training for those looking to make a career change and enter the world of commercial aviation. Ocala Aviation is conveniently located at the Ocala International Airport. So if you're ready to start your adventure, stop by or give them a call today. 861-7484. That's 861-7484. You'll be glad you did. I know I am. Ocala Aviation. Call today. 861-7484.
Got a garden and we've got a show for you called You've Got a Garden with your host, Master Gardener Carol Ann Baldwin. Carol Ann answers your questions about your flowers, your veggies, your grass, your trees, even questions about your bugs. And she's only on WOCA, so don't miss Carol Ann Baldwin and You've Got a Garden each Tuesday from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. right here on WOCA The Source.
Don't get caught without your daily source of senior deals. Pick up your copy of the Senior Voice newspaper. It's your source for schedule and events tailored to seniors with information you need, like a list of free events in the area. We even have Tom's Picks, a free referral for people who are looking for a company to do work for them. Tom's Picks will refer the company to you that fits your needs. And all we ask in return is that you tell them where you heard about them. For more information, call Tom's Picks, 352-804-1223. And pick up your copy of the Senior's Voice at most any business up and down the 200 corridor.
Now read Ocala Downtown Newspaper online.
Do you have areas that have started sagging or drooping? Is what you're looking at not quite the same as it was years ago? Are there enhancements you've been putting off? Is there serious damage you need fixed? Then call on us, Damage Control Services. When your roof is sagging and the drywall is drooping after a storm, or your home just needs some enhancements, from damage repairs to new construction, Damage Control Services is here to help.
Hi, I'm Leah Caruso with Strive Rehabilitation, inviting you to join me Thursday at 11 a.m. for Health Matters. Ocala Health and Strive have teamed up to bring you the latest information on good health services available to you right here at home. This vital information will help you make informed decisions about your health. So don't forget to join me here at 11 a.m. Thursday. It's news you can use from Ocala Health, Strive, and your friends here at WOCA.
We are The Source, WOCA.
You're listening to the Glenn Beck Program.
We want to thank Grover Norquist for taking time and spending it with us peasants tonight at 5 o'clock.
Or is he?
We don't know. But yesterday we were too small to worry about, and today he'll spend it with the peasants. So we are grateful sincerely that he will humble himself and come on the program today and talk to the few scattered people that happen to be watching tonight at 5 o'clock.
Really anxious to see what he has to say, because you know, these ties are pretty close, and they're like Abdul Rahman El Moody is in prison now for for terrorist related
crimes. My guess
crimes.
Is he's going to say, "I really didn't know him." My guess is.
What else can he say?
He is as close to these guys as the president is to Bill Ayers. Right. I didn't even know them.
Yes.
I mean, it is. If I hadn't have investigated the president and all of his ties and all of the things that the Tides Foundation has done, I wouldn't recognize this system. But because I recognize the Tides Foundation, I know exactly what's happening here. This
same
is
thing.
The Tides
yeah, it's the
of
same thing.
The right.
And you laid out that case pretty well. Here was some of what Abdul Rahman Alamoudi, this is who he is, and you kind of presented that really well last night.
I am sure that the United States of America and Israel will come to terms with Hamas. What I don't agree with you, that you show this names, Muhammad this and this, and then you say, these people were training people to do firebombs, to train for this, and you don't show any of that evidence.
Mr. Alamoudi, is Hamas a terrorist group?
No, it's not.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. It's not a terrorist group. 2 years later, he was caught talking about the destruction of America. Watch.
And I think if we are outside this country, we can say no Allah destroyed America. But once we are here...
So that's kind of hard to understand what he's saying. But he's saying when you're outside the country, you can say we should destroy America. But when you're
When you're here...
When you're here...
Our mission in this country is to change. You can be violent anywhere else but in America.
So you can claim violence and call for violence anywhere but inside America. Now, Grover Norquist is working with this guy at this time, and he will say, I didn't know any of these things. I didn't know any of these things.
Uh-huh.
How did you not know this? You're taking money from this guy.
Yeah, something like $20,000 to start
to start the Islamic Institute.
Yeah.
Got it. So once you're here, you can't say those things. He declared support for radical Hamas leader Marzouk, saying, and I quote, I have known Musa Abu Marzouk before, and I really consider him to be among some of the best people in the Islamic movement.
Tell me who that is.
Musa Mohammed Abu Marzouk is a political leader of Hamas. He was also one of the founders of the Holy Land Foundation here in Dallas.
Which, by the way, Grover Norquist's allies fought hard on the Holy Land Foundation situation.
And of course, the Holy Land Foundation was
shut down
because of terrorist organization
and
activities.
It indicted people like CARE and ISNA and everything else.
They were unindicted co-conspirators.
And
right?
said those are Muslim Brotherhood front groups.
Feds caught him expressing frustration that no Americans died in 1998 in the U.S. Embassy bombing in Kenya. He recommended more operations be conducted there. In 2000, he stood across from the White House voicing support for terrorist organizations Hamas and Hezbollah. Watch.
I have been labeled by the media in New York to be a supporter of Hamas. Anybody support this Hamas here?
Yeah!
Anybody is a supporter of Hamas here?
Yeah!
Everybody having a good time.
Anybody is a supporter of Hamas here?
He thinks he's in a rock concert.
Yeah, I can't hear you. Is everybody having
who's
a good time?
Who's supporting Hamas? Rock on!
Hear that, Bill Clinton. We are all supporters of Hamas. Allahu Akbar.
Allah Akbar.
I wish they added Allah. That I'm also a supporter of Hezbollah. Anybody supports Hezbollah here?
Yeah!
Anybody supports Hezbollah here?
Yeah!
Put your hands in the air like you just don't care.
Takbir.
Yeah.
Got it?
Amazing.
Okay, stop for a second. You know who paid for that?
No.
Who paid for that rally? Grover Norquist. This is when he says,
jeez.
Oh my gosh, I didn't know until that moment.
It was a rally for freedom.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I didn't have any idea until somebody pointed out what they were saying on stage. I had no idea. Really? Really? Because they don't seem to be hiding it.
No, they're proud of it.
Yes.
They're proud of it.
This guy was finally arrested at Heathrow Airport with $340,000 in cash that was given to him by Muammar Gaddafi. The plot involved al-Qaeda operatives. He was a senior al-Qaeda financier. He funneled at least $1 million directly to al-Qaeda.
I want to ask you a question, though. Who among us hasn't gotten about $340,000, $350,000 from Muammar Gaddafi? Who among us?
Have.
I mean, let's
we
not
all have.
Let him throw the first stone at this guy, is
right.
what I say.
To kill the crown prince of Saudi Arabia. Who hasn't gotten that money?
Oh, I think double that last
week.
I wasn't going to do it. I just took the money.
Yeah,
that's right. Yeah. Yeah.
And Grover knows nothing of this, of course.
No, Grover knows nothing of it.
Nothing.
No,
it's all news to him.
He doesn't know anything about that. Now, his right-hand man with the Islamic Institute, so Al-Moody, the guy who was arrested, he writes two $10,000 checks, and we have the checks. Okay?
Yeah, showed them on screen last
night. We have the checks written by Al-Moody to Grover Norquist to be able to start the Islamic Institute. But he didn't know anything about this guy. He barely even knows him. Okay? I know I get that kind of stuff all the time, you know, from complete strangers who I then set up in front of the White House to chant "Who loves Hamas?" It happens to me all the time.
Oh, all the time.
Okay? So then when he finds out, okay, he's a bad guy, he takes Al-Moody's number two guy, Khalid Safouri. This is his right-hand man. The guy who goes to prison, this is his right-hand man, and he makes him the co-founder of the Islamic Institute. So it's Grover and Khalid Safouri.
You know who this sounds like is Barack Obama with all of his associations. Remember when he, you know, Bill Ayers is a neighbor. He's our kids play together. We're in a foundation together. Rashid Khalidi? Yeah, I know.
You mentioned Rashid Khalidi, who's a professor at Columbia.
Right.
I do know him because he taught at the University of Chicago.
This is the way it's going to happen.
And
he is Palestinian. This is tonight's interview.
And I do know
he's Palestinian.
And I have had conversations. He is not one
Talk
of my advisors.
Not an
he's
advisor.
Not one of my foreign policy people.
That's exactly. He'll take a page out of the Obama playbook and say he's not an advisor.
Now,
I'm
here,
not getting advice from
here,
these guys.
Members of the NRA, members of CPAC, members of the American Conservative Union, members of the Center for National Interest, members of the Parental Rights Organization, members of the Hispanic Leadership Fund, members of the American Society for Competitiveness, members of the American Spectator, Americans associated with the GOP Proud. I just want you to know, if you had a problem with the president saying, well, I didn't really know Bill Ayers, he was a neighbor of mine. Well, Rashid Khalidi, I didn't. I mean, he was a professor.
He's a Palestinian. He's a professor.
We didn't really even know each other. If you had a problem with any of that.
Made a few bombs together, right?
If you had a problem with any of that and said, who in their right mind believes that? You have to ask yourself, why the hell are you believing Grover Norquist? Because it's going to be the same kind of answer tonight. And the checks and the. And listen. Here's what Grover, and this is what I put out last night. Karl Rove, the Koch brothers, who I don't have any problems really with the Koch brothers. Karl Rove, Koch brothers, Al-Moody, Khalid Safouri, Sami Al-Aryan, Jamal Al-Barzinski, Suhail Khan. Those are the people that are surrounding Grover Norquist. Okay? The people that have come out to me and said, Glenn, you can put my name on the air. You can talk about me. You can say, yes, I believe he's a very dangerous man. James Woolsey, the former director of the CIA. Michelle Malkin, is she an extremist? Is she well-researched or is she a conspiracy theorist? General Jerry Boykin, one of the founding members of the Delta team. Is he a conspiracy theorist or
also
is he a well-reasoned man?
Head of the Family Research Council.
Yes. Eric Stackelbeck. Is he a conspiracy theorist? Patrick Poole. David Horowitz. David Horowitz can see connections and bad guys a million miles away because he was one of the bad guys. He knows how this works. Frank Gaffney. Joe Schmitz was the inspector general for the Pentagon or the Department of Defense. These guys, I know these guys. I trust these guys. Beyond those names, there are names that I cannot put on the chalkboard because they have asked not to be involved.
But you know them.
Yes, and you know them as a listener. You know them and you trust them.
Yep.
A really, really trustworthy people. But they have come out and said, my relationship with Grover Norquist is how I gained this information, and he wields enormous power, and I'm telling you, he is a very grave danger. Please don't stop. One of these told me a year ago I was wrong, and it caused me pause because I really trust this individual.
Because he was a friend of Grover's.
He was a friend of Grover's. He called me and he said, Glenn, when I said it, I didn't call him. He called me. When I first started talking about this on the air here recently, he called me and he said, Glenn, you cannot use my name. He said, because it's very complex. He said, but I'm telling you right now, I was wrong a year ago. I was dreadfully wrong. And he said, please continue to do what you're doing. You must expose him. His connections are at best gravely concerning.
Because he trusted you and what you were saying, he actually looked into it, right? Yeah. He took the time.
Yeah, he said, I took the time looked into it, and I poked around. And found out
it was true.
Yeah, and he said, it's absolutely true, and it is gravely disturbing. Don't stop. So you can trust Alamudi, Safuri, Sami Alarian, Suhail Khan.
And I do.
Karl Rove. You can trust those guys.
I trust Suhail Khan as much as Kubla.
Right.
And Genghis.
Right. Or you can trust the people that I trust. There's no smoking gun here. There's not going to be one gotcha moment. You have to use your gut. If this were about policy, because, for instance, he is for open borders, amnesty. Okay, that's a policy difference. And that's something that I don't go on the air and say, he's a gravely dangerous man because he wants... I think that's a really bad mistake. I think that's really horrible. But that's a policy difference. What this is about the Muslim Brotherhood, knowingly or unknowingly, being spread throughout our system exactly the way the Muslim Brotherhood in the project stated they would do. This is about the end of our republic and the civilization, if it is right. This is one that you don't fool around with. This is not a matter of opinion. This is a matter of security.
Do you remember the Muslim from, I think, Canada, the imam?
Yes.
Who told us about the infiltration at the White House?
Yes.
Instead of bringing victory over the fascist forces of the Muslim Brotherhood, we now recognize that their infiltration is right up to the American White House. But we can't say that.
Except he did. And he said that years ago.
You know what? Let's get him back on.
And who was it? Who was it that brought that infiltration
home? Grover Norquist.
Grover Norquist.
Mm-hmm. So, and with the help of Karl Rove, if you want to know why we pussyfoot around, it's Grover Norquist. He's going to be on tonight at 5 o'clock, an episode you don't want to miss, and I would urge you to share it with all of your friends.
It's, by the way, free tonight.
It's free tonight, so you can watch. You can sign up for The Blaze if you'd like, and then you'd get last night's episode, which is really well worth it, and then the two-hour special from For the Record on the project for the Muslim Brotherhood. You can sign up at theblaze.com/TV, or tonight's episode is free. Make sure you watch it and tell a friend to watch it. And, of course, we'll play the clips on tomorrow's radio program. But it's well worth your time. Sponsor this half hour is Simply Safe. Is your home protected around the clock? Are you in a long-term contract? Most alarm companies will trap you. They'll play on your love for your family and your concerns, and then they lock you into a contract. And, it's like $60 a month, $50 or $60. For $14.99 a month, you can have 24/7 security on your house without a contract. So nobody's locking you in. You're not stuck with them. No long-term contracts, no commitments. You're free to start, stop, cancel at any time. And Simply Safe is the new way to keep your family safe for half the price of other companies. 24/7 professional monitoring is $14.99 a month. It's the best value in home security. Round-the-clock protection, exceptional savings, and no long-term contracts. Get peace of mind for your home. Go to simplysafebeck.com. Go now, get 10% off. simplysafebeck.com.
The fusion of entertainment and enlightenment.
This
is the Glenn Beck Program, the Blaze Radio Network.
Hi, this is Wayne Allen Root, the capitalist evangelist. Many know me as a former vice presidential nominee, best-selling author, or former anchor at Financial News Network. Today, I travel the world looking for exciting opportunities, and I found one in Black Gold Resources. Even in a bad economy, savvy investors can diversify their portfolios for steady monthly income and powerful tax advantages with oil well ownership. Legendary investment guru Benjamin Graham's philosophy was to buy low and sell high, and that's exactly how I feel about the price of oil today. Worldwide oil demand has soared from 20 billion to over 33 billion barrels annually. Black Gold's projects are specially designed with no dry hole drilling risk. Plus, you can use your IRA funds. If you're a qualified investor looking for long-term steady monthly income and have at least $40,000 to start, call us now at 800-255-1236. That's 800-255-1236. That's toll-free 800-255-1236.
Hey, Matt, I know Sunrise Automotive does auto stuff, but I need some tires for my truck. Can you recommend someone?
Yes, I can. We do that.
No, I mean, I need them installed and balanced and all that.
Yep, we do that.
Well, my son needed his windows tinted.
Yep, we do that.
I need my seat replaced.
Yep, we do that too.
I need a new roofline and a new spoiler and a new truck.
Yep, we can even do that too.
Okay, I get it. I suppose you can also do a radio show too, huh?
Well, as a matter of fact, join me every Monday at 10 for auto repair with personal care here on The Source.
Of course you do.
One of the most common questions those nearing retirement are asking, will I outlive my money? Retirement questions like these and many more will be answered every Saturday morning at 9 a.m. on Planning for a Better and Safer Retirement with hosts Francois and Julian Cozenet. Francois and Julian will help you put your retirement puzzle together. Catch Planning for a Better and Safer Retirement Saturdays at 9 a.m. on Ocala's News Talk, The Source 96.3 FM and 1370 AM.
Real estate is the largest and most personal investment that any of us will ever make. Be sure to tune in Tuesdays at 10 a.m. when Bob Kennedy, owner of Berkshire Hathaway Home Team Realty, will be answering your questions and discussing real estate. So remember, that's Tuesdays at 10 a.m. Call 622-9622 with your questions. It pays to be an informed buyer or seller. This is news you can use from Berkshire Hathaway Home Team Realty and your friends here at WOCA.
Hi, I'm Seth with AA Lock, Dock, and Security. Have you ever thought about the locks or security on your house or business? Have you ever wondered why the keys to your new car cost so much? Well, at AA Lock, Dock, and Security, we can help with securing your valuables. We can even replace those expensive transponder keys. We can give you the knowledge that no one else will. Call AA Lock, Dock, and Security at 867-1965. That's 867-1965.
Weekends are getting a little retooled.
Swear to God, not making a joke.
Check this out.
New shows?
Check.
We are Buzzworth. Some new talent?
Check.
Let's welcome the guys.
Let's get it going.
Arnie Spanier.
Unbelievable.
TJ Reeves.
This is what you get.
Your weekends are on fire.
Because that's how exotic it is.
We are Buzzworth.
Get it for less at the DIY Home Center Outlet. Get top quality real wood cabinets the same or less than the big box stores are selling the cheap stuff. And that's not all. Drywall screws big box stores are $6.47 a pound. At DIY, only $4.99. Plus, DIY has the largest selection of mobile home parts and accessories anywhere. From carpet to doors, get the DIY supplies you need for less. The DIY Home Center Outlet. We are your building material closeout store. 2191 Northwest 10th Street, just 2 miles east of I-75.
Some disturbing news coming out of Germany today. The plane crash. French prosecutor now says the co-pilot crashed the plane deliberately, knew exactly what he was doing, and crashed it into the side of the mountain. Of course, nobody's talking about terrorism now. They're talking about suicide. That's not suicide. That's murder. And
mass murder.
Mass murder. Lufthansa crash. That opens up all kinds of possibilities. And we'll keep our eye on that as well. Back in a minute.
You're listening to the Glenn Beck Program.
The Blaze Radio Network.
You know that small businesses can lose a lot of money every year because, well, their information online isn't accurate. Inaccurate information means future and existing customers can't find you, and if they can't find you, they can't pay you. YP is the leader in local marketing solutions, and they are here to help you with this. You might run your business, it's your passion. Online marketing is probably not your passion. YP does this for you. 80 million people search YP for local business every single month, and they know the importance about they know how important it is to be found and get your information correct. They will offer you a free business scan. It measures your business's online health and checks the accuracy of your listings. In just seconds, the YP scan is going to tell you where you're listed, where your information is right, where it's not, and get you the information you need to improve your business. Check your listings and get your free business scan. Make sure they can find you. MyFreeYP.com, MyFreeYP.com, MyFreeYP.com.
Have you ever thought you'd like to buy and sell houses but didn't know how or where to begin? Do you fear your job is in jeopardy, or is your business income reduction keeping you awake at night? We're in the best time in 25 years to make a fortune in real estate without using your money or credit. My name is Ron LeGrand, and I've taught 500,000 people to do just that and personally bought hundreds of houses myself. If you'll call 800-970-6156, 24 hours, and leave your information, I'll send you the first 500 callers my hot new CD, Foreclosure Fortunes, and my best-selling book to help you get started absolutely free. I'll show you how to build a six-figure income part-time with no previous experience and no license, even if you're a busy professional. Call 800-970-6156, 24 hours, and get my new book and CD free. That's 800-970-6156. Take your life back and make this your best year ever. Call 800-970-6156.
Are you tired of not using your home's outdoor space for entertaining or relaxation because of all the bugs and leaves? Consider adding a beautiful screen room or glass enclosure. We are Superior Aluminum and Design, a family-owned and operated business with 20 years' experience in the aluminum industry, and we are accredited by the Better Business Bureau. If you appreciate superior workmanship, call Superior Aluminum and Design at 817-8058 or visit us on the web at superioraluminumdesign.com.
One of the most common questions those nearing retirement are asking, will I outlive my money? Retirement questions like these and many more will be answered every Saturday morning at 9 a.m. on Planning for a Better and Safer Retirement with hosts Francois and Julian Cozenet. Francois and Julian will help you put your retirement puzzle together. Catch Planning for a Better and Safer Retirement Saturdays at 9 a.m. on Ocala's News Talk, The Source 96.3 FM and 1370 AM.
Broadcasting from the Paddock Mall Studios, this is WOCA, Ocala, Gainesville, The Villages, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, The Source.
Fox News Radio, I'm Lillian Wu. Safety measures are supposed to keep intruders from the cockpit, but in the case of the crashed Germanwings flight, the danger came from within, from the co-pilot.
After early analysis of the cockpit voice recorder, prosecutors in France say it appears he crashed the plane deliberately, locking the pilot outside the cockpit and calmly sending the plane down, killing all 150 people on board. The principal of a German high school, which lost 16 students in the crash, saying today's developments make things even worse.
Fox Radio's Simon Owen. A series of tornadoes slamming into the Midwest.
The spring's first round of twisters destroying the gymnastics center and damaging a mobile home park in Sand Springs in suburban Tulsa, where one person was killed. There's damage in Oklahoma City and in Moore, where cars and big rigs were flipped over last night.
Fox Radio's Jeff Minasso. And fewer Americans filed for first-time jobless help last week. Fox News. We report, you decide.
I'm Lex Friedman. I run my own business, so I know from experience, hiring new employees can be tough. Posting your job in one place isn't enough to find quality candidates. If you want to find the perfect hire, you need to post your job on all the top job sites. And now you can, with ZipRecruiter.com. you can post your job to 50-plus job sites, including social networks like Facebook and Twitter, all with a single click. Find candidates in any industry nationwide. Just post once and watch your qualified candidates roll in to ZipRecruiter's easy-to-use interface. And with ZipRecruiter's premium traffic boost, you can get up to 3 times more candidates. Quickly screen applicants, rate them, and hire the right person fast. Find out why ZipRecruiter has been used by over 200,000 businesses. Right now, our listeners can try ZipRecruiter for free. Plus, get 30% off your first traffic boost by going to ZipRecruiter.com/info. That's ZipRecruiter.com/info. One more time, to try it for free, go to ZipRecruiter.com/info.
Hi, Danny Werfel here. Get moving with Florida Credit Union's fast and easy loan approval process.
Let Florida Credit Union start up a new car loan for you today. No more waiting, hassles, or stop signs. You can even apply online. With a strong financial team behind you, you can enjoy great rates and fast approvals.
It's all about personalized service and a streamlined process.
Florida Credit Union, connecting your money to your life.
Real estate is the largest and most personal investment that any of us will ever make. Be sure to tune in Tuesdays at 10 a.m. when Bob Kennedy, owner of Berkshire Hathaway Home Team Realty, will be answering your questions and discussing real estate. So remember, that's Tuesdays at 10 a.m. Call 622-9622 with your questions. It pays to be an informed buyer or seller. This is news you can use from Berkshire Hathaway Home Team Realty and your friends here at WOCA.
Career Source Citrus Levy Marion brings together business and community partners, economic development leaders, and educational providers to connect employers with qualified, skilled talent and job seekers with employment and career development opportunities. Tune in the first and third Wednesday of each month at 9:30 a.m. to Career Source Citrus Levy Marion and learn how they can help you.
That was the sound of a tree falling. It could be your tree. You're going to have it trimmed, but never got around to calling Pride Tree Service. It could have fallen in a field, and now all you have to do is call Pride Tree Service, and they'll have it quickly out of the way for a great price. But don't wait until the tree falls. It may not fall in the field. It may hit your car, your house, or worse. So call Pride Tree Service today and avoid all those headaches before they happen. Pride Tree Service, 840-0750. That's 840-0750.
Let's give it up for old asphalt and a new pair of shoes. Let's give it up for a good rhythm meeting a sweet melody. For a church cookout under clear skies. Let's give it up for good things coming together, like bundling your auto and other policies together with an Allstate agent, which can save you time and keep you better protected. Let's give it up for good.
To receive your comparative insurance quote, contact the McDonald Agency at 622-2333.
Located next door to Silver Spring State Park and a few minutes from historic downtown Ocala, our award-winning Holiday Inn Express Hotel and Suites of Silver Springs is the place to stay for a friendly, memorable, and fun experience. Enjoy our fast and free Wi-Fi, complimentary hot breakfast, and free parking. Whether you're in town for work or play, our friendly staff will make you feel right at home. That's the Holiday Inn Express and Suites of Silver Springs.
Proud sponsor of College of Central Florida basketball on WOCA The Source.
So you need a credit card, but how do you choose? Let's compare the big banks to Florida Credit Union. They have rewards, and we do too. They have customer service. Hello, 24/7. They have celebrities. Hey, Danny. But with Florida Credit Union, there's no annual fee, no liability for fraudulent charges, and no 22% interest rates. Choose Florida Credit Union, and you'll not only have a great credit card, but you'll have the support and personal touch that the big banks, well, can't touch. Florida Credit Union, connecting your money to your life. Federally insured by the NCUA.
If you missed Southern Pigskin Tonight recently, you missed Urban Meyer talking about what it takes to man up.
You hear the term man up or next man ready, and everyone says that. We've certainly been a part of situations where that hasn't happened, where the next man wasn't ready. Obviously, the credit goes to the player first.
So join us every Thursday at 5 p.m. for Southern Pigskin Tonight, right here on 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, WOCA, The Source.
We all want to belong,
about to hear is the fusion of entertainment and enlightenment. This is the Glenn Beck Program.
Welcome to the program. I want to introduce you to a couple of people that we had come in because Grover Norquist had canceled his appearance on television tonight because it was just too small and we were too humble and too shabby to appear on. And then this morning, for some unknown reason, they decided, no, that's not what we said. We want to be on the show. So they're going to be on the show, and I'm making it for free so everybody can watch it tonight. Grover Norquist is going to be there to answer a few questions on his relationship to some of the worst people in the Muslim world and the connections to their organizations, to the Muslim Brotherhood, and his connections to them. He has been, I think that we are talking about a guy who is a mini Tides Foundation for the right. I think he is laundering people, knowingly or unknowingly, I don't know, but he's a Harvard grad, so he's not a moron, which makes it hard to believe he doesn't know what's going on, but we'll see tonight. But I brought a couple of people in. First of all, Patrick Poole, who came in for yesterday's show. He's national security and terrorism correspondent for PJ Media and has helped us a lot over the last few years, trying to get to the bottom of some of the ties of terrorism and Muslim Brotherhood. Also, Joseph Schmitz, he is the former IG for the Department of Defense. In fact, if you become an inspector general, you get the handbook on how to be an inspector general written by him. So he's not a guy without some credibility and not a crackpot or a conspiracy theorist. And that's what Grover and his allies always call people who say, hey, you're connected to a lot of really bad people. You're immediately called a racist or a conspiracy theorist. We learned that from Saul Alinsky, and we learned that from the Obama administration. That's the way you make your enemies go away. I'm so tired of that. It no longer affects me. I don't really care. I just want to know the answers because we are dealing with national security. So, gentlemen, welcome to the program. And I'm sorry that it's going to be an interesting day. We're going to have you guys actually talk to the viewers as the show is going on. I don't know if they've discussed this with you, but we want you to be able to correct the record, and you'll be live blogging during the show, and then we'll also talk to you after the show and see what you guys have to say about some of his answers, if it lasts the full hour. Otherwise, if it doesn't last the full hour, we'll bring you in, and then we'll have a conversation about his answers. You've seen, Joe, I talked to Patrick last night, but you saw the show last night. Did you see it?
I actually was flying out here last night.
You were flying out,
so
okay.
I missed the show.
I'm wondering if you look at these chalkboards and you see who he is, what he's done, and then the people he trusts, and then the things that the people that he trusts set up. Founding member of the American Muslim Council, the American Muslim Foundation, the Islamic Society of Boston. I mean, one of the reasons why I think we didn't investigate the Boston Mosque over and over and over again is because possibly of Grover Norquist's ties. He's whitewashing everybody. He's laundering everybody. Is there something to be said for that? Do you think that's what's going on?
Well, you know, as a former inspector general, I'm always interested in the facts, and you've laid out some pretty compelling facts to be asking further questions. So I think you're on track. And, you know, there's a classic maxim in debate that if somebody resorts to ad hominems, you know, you're winning on the merits.
Right.
So when you mentioned that you get accused of being a Islamophobe.
Well,
or,
not me. Everybody
or,
who
or conspiracy theorist. Yeah. Yeah. You know, it doesn't really bother me. I mean, I'm interested in the facts, and the facts are that Grover Norquist has affiliations. I mean, he founded the Islamic Institute with the gentleman who's now serving a 23, actually, it was a 23-year prison term, but the Obama administration came in 2011 and knocked it from 23 down to 16 and a half. And the documents are sealed, so we don't really know why the Obama administration did that.
You were concerned when you were the IG of the Defense Department of the people that were put in as clerics for the chaplains, correct?
Yes.
And that had Grover's fingerprints all over it.
Well, actually, the same guy who's in prison now, Alan Moody, was the founder of one of the two Islamic cleric endorsing agencies. The other one was an unindicted co-conspirator. The other endorsing agent was an unindicted co-conspirator in the Holy Land Foundation trial. So when Fort Hood happened and it became public that Major Nidal Hassan was a DOD recognized lay leader at Fort Hood, I immediately thought of the study I did, the review I did of the way we vet our chaplains, not just in the Muslim community, but in all the communities. And I have a very distinct recollection of the Department of Defense rejecting my recommendation to do basic national agency checks to make sure that any of our chaplain candidates aren't either themselves being investigated or that their organizational with whom they're affiliated is under investigation, and the DOD rejected that.
Why?
Well, according to the official document, the Office of General Counsel of the Department of Defense had First Amendment concerns. Glenn, I used to teach First Amendment law. I'm an expert on the First Amendment. The proposal I made was facially neutral. It was 100% constitutional. And it was 100% common sense, and the DOD rejected it.
What do you think really happened?
Well, I think the lawyers in the Pentagon essentially cowered to political correctness. They didn't want to have to face the ACLU or any of these other groups that are, frankly, are pushing the envelope in the wrong direction. And
if they would have accepted your proposal, do you think Fort Hood would have happened?
Possibly. It's hard to say. It's hard to say. But I'm telling you, even after Fort Hood, the head of an unindicted co-conspirator in the largest terrorist financing conviction in the history of the United States was still giving sensitivity training to our soldiers Fort Hood.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, and in fact, Louis Safi, who was the actual endorsing agent for the Islamic Society of North America, is now the political director for the Syrian National Coalition in Qatar. He's literally a foreign agent, and he was the guy up until just a few years ago was certifying our Muslim chaplains.
Now, is there any tie to Grover on these?
Invariably, there are. And one thing I wanted to pick up with Joe, he mentioned the Office of General Counsel. Joe, if I recall correctly, it was the Office of General Counsel that brought Anwar Awlaki into the Pentagon and held the lunchtime session in the executive dining room of the Pentagon just a couple months after three of his spiritual disciples flew a plane into the building. So this was the same Office of General Counsel that scuttled Joe's recommendations.
Well, I think that's right. I don't remember exactly whether it was the Office of General Counsel that hosted, but they almost always approve those type of events. But going back to Glenn's question, there is a connection, at least according to Wikipedia, there's a connection. And according to Wikipedia, the Grover Norquist co-founded the what's called, I think, the Islamic Institute. I think originally it was called the Islamic Free Market Institute.
Yeah, I think it is. I think that's its official name, but it's II, Islamic Institute.
That's right. And according to Wikipedia, Grover co-founded that with
Khalid Safouri.
Khalid Safouri and
Alan Moody,
who is the one who's in prison now.
Right.
And who was the founder of the other Muslim chaplain endorsing agency.
He says that he doesn't, everything that we find he either just immediately calls you a racist or a conspiracy theorist. But the only thing we have found on Alamudi is he said he doesn't really know him, and his relationship wasn't that close, and he had no idea this was a bad guy until he paid for that rally outside of the White House.
Where
he was saying, "Who's here for Hamas? Who's here for Hezbollah?"
Yes, that was in October 2000. And, of course, we have the canceled checks. I can see them here on your desk.
Yes.
Where Alamudi. And at this point, we know of those two checks. There very well may have been more. We also have the Senate lobbying disclosure forms where his lobbying organization, Janus Merit Strategies, listed Alamudi as one of their clients repeatedly.
Now, he says that was a clerical error.
They only said that that was a clerical error years afterwards, after Alamudi had been arrested and his lobbyist, David Savavian, who also went to prison, by the way. This is Grover's, one of his right-hand guys ended up going to prison in the Abramoff scandal. David Savavian listed Alamudi as his client at Janus Merit repeatedly. We have those documents.
The Abramoff scandal we haven't even touched on, but I am told he was at the center of the Abramoff scandal.
Absolutely.
And the only one that really didn't go to prison.
Yeah, he set up a number of the organizations. You know, there was a think tank that was based out of a basement in Rehoboth Beach where they were funneling a lot of this money. Of course, Grover was directly involved in the Indian gambling casino money that ended up being filtered and sent to Ralph Reed. And I mean, there's a whole 2-hour documentary on it called Casino Jack in the United States of Money. And Grover plays a starring role in that documentary. In fact, they made a motion picture with Kevin Spacey out of this whole thing. And he was right smack dab in the middle of that.
Why is the left defending Grover right now? They wanted to take him down. And now all of the ones who are really supporting him, it's all Salon and Media Matters, and they're the ones that are calling me a racist right now for coming after him. I can't figure that one out. Here's a guy they used to say was a bad guy. I mean, we have the New York Times, Wall Street Journal. We have The Nation saying that he's a bad guy. And now all of a sudden he's a good guy. Why?
Yeah, during the Bush administration, these news organizations had no problem raising the fact about Grover's ties to Sami Al-Aryan and Abdurrahman Alamudi. And you mentioned the Franklin Foyer article at The Nation, which we were discussing yesterday. And I mean, it goes into great detail about Grover's contacts. Well, now it's all verboten. You can't mention it or else you're an Islamophobe. There must be kind of a statute of limitations in criticism. But all these news organizations reported on Grover's ties during the Bush administration.
Back in just a second, let me tell you about our sponsor this half hour. It is Intrum Healthcare. Home care is one of those things you don't really want to think about until the time comes when you need it. For most Americans, that time comes as a parent or a loved one starts to become less able and independent, and age begins to take its toll. It's a tough conversation to have with an aging parent. Your mom refuses to even discuss moving into a nursing home, and you don't want to move her into a nursing home, but you're worried about her being alone and climbing the stairs every day. This is where Intrum's deep experience, strong clinical heritage, and reputation as a trusted provider of independent and safe care in people's homes becomes really important. They've been doing this now for 50 years. Intrum offices provide a variety of services directly or help coordinate the kind of home care any person needs. According to the CDC, 1 out of 3 older adults fall every single year, but less than half talk to their healthcare provider about it. Falls are the leading cause of both fatal and non-fatal injuries among adults. The good people at Intrum Healthcare can help you take care in their own home of your parent. IntrumHealthcare.com/Beck. Take their free independent living assessment or call 1-800-944-8888 and locate an Intrum office near you. It's IntrumHealthcare.com/Beck.
Glenn Beck. 888-727-BECK.
The Blaze Radio Network.
I'm Jay Farner with some great news on how you could save an average of $3,000 per year on your mortgage. Call Quicken Loans now at 800-QUICKEN to see if you qualify for the government's Home Affordable Refinance Program, or HARP. The HARP guidelines have changed. There's less paperwork and often no appraisal required. Call 800-QUICKEN. That's 800-QUICKEN, or visit quickenloans.com.
Important terms and conditions apply. Call us for cost information. Equal housing lender. Licensed in all 50 states and NMLS number 3030.
Easter Sunday, April 5th on NBC. From the producers of the epic miniseries The Bible, the next chapter, A.D., The Bible Continues. Producers Mark Burnett and Roma Downey.
A.D., The Bible Continues picks up the story at the crucifixion of Jesus.
A.D. 33, the Romans are starting to lose a grip on power.
These disciples take on the Roman Empire.
This is Game of Thrones meets The Bible.
Do you dare to believe?
A.D., The Bible Continues, Easter Sunday, April 5th on NBC.
Hey, I'm Gary.
And I'm Eric. Did you know that Red Eye Radio is on WOCA The Source every night from 2 to 6 a.m. and it's live?
That's right. No tape shows here.
We know that the news doesn't sleep.
And neither do we. So we're here with you live from 2 till 6 a.m. every weekday. Call us 866-90-RED-EYE. So join me, Gary McNamara.
And me, Eric Harley, every weeknight to discuss the latest in news and entertainment.
Right here on WOCA The Source.
Hey, Matt, I know Sunrise Automotive does auto stuff, but I need some tires for my truck. Can you recommend someone?
Yes, I can. We do that.
No, I mean, I need them installed and balanced and all that.
Yep, we do that.
Well, my son needed his windows tinted.
Yep, we do that.
I need my seat replaced.
Yep, we do that too.
I need a new roofline and a new spoiler and a new truck.
Yep, we can even do that too.
Okay, I get it. I suppose you can also do a radio show too, huh?
Well, as a matter of fact, join me every Monday at 10 for auto repair with personal care here on The Source.
Of course you do.
Good credits, bad credits. It's none of our business because we're not an auto dealer. We're not a bank. We're not your mother. We're OcalaForSale.com, Marion County's marketplace for cars, trucks, and SUVs. We've got thousands of sellers standing by to take your call. No middleman. But hurry, don't walk, don't run. Just sit down and log on to OcalaForSale.com.
Prices and inventory change daily. Offer does not include dealer upcharge. Undercutting, rust proofing, factory surcharge, or delivery fee. See website for details.
Do you have areas that have started sagging or drooping? Is what you're looking at not quite the same as it was years ago? Are there enhancements you've been putting off? Is there serious damage you need fixed? Then call on us, Damage Control Services. When your roof is sagging and the drywall is drooping after a storm, or your home just needs some enhancements, from damage repairs to new construction, Damage Control Services is here to help.
This is the Glenn Beck Program.
We're with Patrick Poole, national security and terrorism correspondent for PJMedia.com, and the former Inspector General of the Department of Defense, Joe Smits. And you were just talking about, you have the docket from Alamudi's trial?
Yes.
Okay. And what were you, take us through this.
I was just pointing out that in the summer of 2011, the Obama administration filed some sealed documents which led to the reduction of Alamudi's 23-year sentence down to about 16 and a half years, which means under the federal system, as I understand it, he could be up for a good behavior release real soon, and we don't really know why his sentence was reduced.
If I had trust for our government, I would say it's because he helped us on something.
Yeah, but think about what our government was doing precisely at that time. This is when the Secretary of State, Hillary Clinton, was over in Paris having secret meetings with the Muslim Brotherhood leaders from Libya. Mm. This is a little bit over a year before
Benghazi.
But it was also, you know, when the Muslim Brotherhood was in charge in Egypt, the Muslim Brotherhood, which is now designated as an international terrorist organization by not only Egypt, but UAE and Saudi Arabia. These are Muslim countries designating the Muslim Brotherhood as an international terrorist organization.
And we won't even admit that.
Well, last month we had the Muslim Brotherhood delegation walk through the front doors of the State Department that Adam Credo at the Washington Free Beacon. We have pictures of this Muslim Brotherhood delegation inside the State Department.
How
last
instrumental
month.
Do you think Grover Norquist was in the whitewashing of the Muslim Brotherhood?
Well, certainly he shouted down anybody who tried to raise concerns about it, particularly during the Bush administration when it was his buddies. You know, during the break, I was just looking through my notes. In April 2001, Grover led a delegation of 80-some-odd Muslim leaders from very notorious organizations like Triple IT, like CARE, like Alamudi's American Muslim Council. And we have the Secret Service list for all those who attended that meeting. Grover's right at the top. Khaled Safari, his deputy, is number two. And David Savavian, his lobbyist for Janet Merritt Strategies, is right there. I mean, Grover was walking these guys right into the White House.
Who's doing this on the left? Because we have pictures of these guys with the Clintons as well.
At this point, there isn't a figure like Grover. Now they have direct access, whether it's Salam al-Mariati from MPAC, CARE. They are granted direct access. They don't need a mediator to be able to get into the Obama White House.
Because of the work that Grover did.
Well, Grover certainly mainstreamed these organizations back during the Bush administration. And like we talked about during the program last night, when Sami Alarian went to trial, he said, you know, I can't be a terrorist. You know, here I am with the Attorney General. Here I am at the White House, et cetera. And those were all meetings that were arranged by Grover and his associates.
We have a list of the boards that Grover is on. National Rifle Association, American Conservative Union, Center for National Interest, Parental Rights Organization, Hispanic Leadership Fund, American Society for Competitiveness, The American Spectator, and GOP Proud. Is it disturbing to you that a guy with these ties is on the board of directors, or is this something that we shouldn't worry about? Any opinion from either of you guys?
Well, you know what? As I said, I focus on the facts. The facts that he is affiliated publicly with Muslim Brotherhood front organizations in the United States, and he's on these boards, is a big red flag. Not a yellow flag. That's a big red flag.
Okay. Back in just a second. 888-727-BECK.
The Glenn Beck Program.
The Blaze Radio Network.
Fox News Radio. I'm Lillian Wu. Safety measures are supposed to keep intruders from the cockpit, but in the case of the crashed Germanwings flight, the danger came from within, from the co-pilot.
After
apparently.
Early analysis of the cockpit voice recorder, prosecutors in France say it appears he crashed the plane deliberately, locking the pilot outside the cockpit and calmly sending the plane down, killing all 150 people on board. The principal of a German high school, which lost 16 students in the crash, saying today's developments make things even worse.
Fox Radio Simon Owen. A series of tornadoes slamming into the Midwest.
The spring's first round of twisters destroying the gymnastics center and damaging a mobile home park in Sand Springs in suburban Tulsa, where one person was killed. There's damage in Oklahoma City and in Moore, where cars and big rigs were flipped over last night.
Fox Radio's Jeff Minasso. And fewer Americans filed for first-time jobless help last week. Fox News. We report. You decide.
I'm Lex Friedman. I run my own business, so I know from experience, hiring new employees can be tough. Posting your job in one place isn't enough to find quality candidates. If you want to find the perfect hire, you need to post your job on all the top job sites. And now you can, with ZipRecruiter.com. You can post your job to 50-plus job sites, including social networks like Facebook and Twitter, all with a single click. Find candidates in any industry nationwide. Just post once and watch your qualified candidates roll in to ZipRecruiter's easy-to-use interface. And with ZipRecruiter's premium traffic boost, you can get up to 3 times more candidates. Quickly screen applicants, rate them, and hire the right person fast. Find out why ZipRecruiter has been used by over 200,000 businesses. Right now, our listeners can try ZipRecruiter for free. Plus, get 30% off your first traffic boost by going to ZipRecruiter.com/info. That's ZipRecruiter.com/info. One more time. To try it for free, go to ZipRecruiter.com/info.
Hi, I'm Seth with AA Lock, Dock, and Security. Have you ever thought about the locks or security on your house or business? Have you ever wondered why the keys to your new car cost so much? Well, at AA Lock, Dock, and Security, we can help with securing your valuables. We can even replace those expensive transponder keys. We can give you the knowledge that no one else will. Call AA Lock, Dock, and Security at 867-1965. That's 867-1965.
Here's a way for you to have some fun and at the same time support Team WOCA The Source in our efforts to raise funds for the Marion County Literacy Council. You can have Robin and I come to your event or somebody else's event. I play accordion, she plays mandolin, and we'll give the oompa surprise to somebody who may not be expecting it. So call us at 732-8000, ask for Robin. 100% of your donation of any amount will go to the Marion County Literacy Council, and it is tax deductible. Call today, 732-8000.
Hi, Danny Werfel here. Get moving with Florida Credit Union's fast and easy loan approval process.
Let Florida Credit Union start up a new car loan for you today. No more waiting, hassles, or stop signs. You can even apply online. With a strong financial team behind you, you can enjoy great rates and fast approvals.
It's all about personalized service and a streamlined process.
Florida Credit Union, connecting your money to your life.
Real estate is the largest and most personal investment that any of us will ever make. Be sure to tune in Tuesdays at 10 a.m. when Bob Kennedy, owner of Berkshire Hathaway Home Team Realty, will be answering your questions and discussing real estate. So remember, that's Tuesdays at 10 a.m. Call 622-9622 with your questions. It pays to be an informed buyer or seller. This is news you can use from Berkshire Hathaway Home Team Realty and your friends here at WOCA.
Career Source Citrus Levy Marion brings together business and community partners, economic development leaders, and educational providers to connect employers with qualified, skilled talent and job seekers with employment and career development opportunities. Tune in the first and third Wednesday of each month at 9:30 a.m. to Career Source Citrus Levy Marion and learn how they can help you.
Putting the local back into radio. 24 hours a day, 365 days a year. WOCA News. Variety. Information. Now. Keep your arms and legs on the inside at all times.
The most trusted name in news, Fox News. Every half hour, only on 96.3 FM, 1370 AM, The Source.
WOCA.
Program. We're talking a little bit about Grover Norquist. He is going to be my guest tonight. I'm making this episode free so you can watch it. Last night, I kind of did the Fox thing and pulled out my chalkboards and dusted them off and tried to show you the connections and how disturbing these connections really are and how they are all connected to the Muslim Brotherhood. And if you are familiar, if you buy the line that the Muslim Brotherhood is largely secular, they have Muslim in their name, they're largely secular and they're a peace group, well, then you're too far gone to save anyway. If you know who the Muslim Brotherhood is, you know how dangerous these connections are. Grover canceled yesterday. I got a note during the show that he was not going to be on the show. And then he then wrote this morning and said, you know, I didn't mean that. I meant I wanted to be on the show. So he's going to be on tonight. And I will tell you that it's going to be one of those shows that, like we had, we have had in the past. I think I know his answers, and I think he's going to try to make this into race baiting or smearing other people. This is not about other people. It's not about his family. It's not about him personally. This is about his connections. And I want to get the straight answers on the connections, period. And I have very little tolerance for people that try to grandstand or change the subject. And I'm just not going to play any games. So he's going to be on with us at 5 o'clock. It is free. You'll be able to watch it. You'll be able to blog with us during the episode. We will make that available and explain that to you a little later on in the program today. But I brought in Joe Schmidt. He is Schmitz. He is the former Inspector General of the Department of Defense and the guy who literally wrote the textbook on Inspector Generals, the handbook for Inspector Generals, a very reasoned and rational guy that whose voice needs to be heard more and more. Also, Patrick Poole, he's National Security and Terrorism Correspondent for PJMedia.com. And a guy who has really helped us over the years, works closely with For the Record, and tries to get to the bottom of all of the connections of Islamic terror. Patrick, I want to talk to you a little bit about where I left off. I'm concerned that Grover is on all of these boards. The National Rifle Association is one of them, because if you know what the Muslim Brotherhood Project is, you know their goal was to get agents of influence into the boardrooms of America, into our culture, mainstream them, and then slowly exert their influence. This is why we can't say anything anymore. This is why we're so politically correct, because these agents of influence have tremendous power at the highest levels. We were talking a little bit about Grover when he was on the board of directors of CPAC, and he was... Well, you tell the story because you know it firsthand. Tell me what his influence on a board means.
Well, one of the reasons he's there is because of the money he brings to the table. That's why he's on all these boards, and that's largely why he was on the board of the American Conservative Union. Both he and his pal Suhail Khan was the money that they were helping to keep ACU afloat and CPAC. And not just Grover, but particularly Suhail made a big thing about the fact of the people that were now excluded from speaking at CPAC because they had fallen out of favor and were raising these concerns about the Muslim Brotherhood. You know, we see how well that foreign policy worked out in the Middle East,
correct.
Over the past couple years, embracing the so-called moderate Muslim Brotherhood, and for I've been to the CPAC for the past 8 years, I think, and national security was absent for a number of years. I mean, there weren't any panels about the collapse of our foreign policy. Mm-hmm. And Grover and Suhail were architects of that, keeping the people out who were raising concerns about our engaging the moderate Islamists like the Muslim Brotherhood, or us partnering with Abdelhakim Belhaj, the Libyan al-Qaeda figure, who we have pictures with, not just Democrats, but with John McCain and Lindsey Graham. The CIA renditioned him back to Libya, and this is the guy that we backed to overthrow Gaddafi. People who were raising concerns about that at the time, and there was nothing said about it at CPAC.
And that's, you believe, because of Grover's influence?
Well, certainly Suhail went out publicly and
was... Explain the connection to Suhail and who Suhail is.
Well, Suhail is a very close associate of Grover. I mean, there are pictures of... there was a picture I remember from the National Journal of... Grover at one of his Wednesday morning meetings, and you can see Suhail sitting directly behind him. Grover helped get Suhail his position as the lobbyist for Microsoft. That's currently his position, and you know, got him the position on the American Conservative Union board, the group that runs CPAC.
This is what's so disturbing is these guys have been whitewashed so much that they can go work for Microsoft at the highest levels. They can go into these boardrooms. Who's working for Seagram's? Who's on the board of Seagram's?
Well, certainly Seagram's was a longtime client of Grover's, and sponsored a lot of his events. That's I think that's part of the question when you raise the topic of these boards, and he brings money to the table to these organizations, is where is that money coming from?
Correct. This has all been done in the name of tolerance. We are being taught to be tolerant, and that is a good thing to a point, isn't it, Joe?
You know, if you ask any group of people, typically, are you in favor of tolerance? Most of the hands will go immediately up. Instinctively, we like tolerance.
Correct.
But you know, there's a famous Nobel laureate by the name of Thomas Mann, who escaped Germany in 1928 and became an American. In one of his books, he says, tolerance becomes a crime when applied to evil. Hmm. And if you really think about it, and the people that will raise their hands and say, instinctively, I'm in favor of tolerance, well, and then you ask them the question, well, do you tolerate human slavery? Well, no, we don't tolerate that.
Correct.
Well, do you tolerate, child abuse? No, we don't tolerate that. So tolerance has its limits. And, the idea of agents of influence in our society is not new. We had British agents of influence literally spying on our forefathers during the American Revolutionary War. During the Second World War, leading up, literally at the same time when Thomas Mann was escaping what became Nazi Germany, we had the Bruderbund, mm-hmm. which was very, very active in trying to influence American public policy.
Right.
You know, during the Cold War, we have documented time after time agents of influence from the Soviet Communist Party trying to influence American foreign policy.
Alger Hiss, and what's fascinating about Alger Hiss, it is so striking with agents of influence and the way Grover Norquist. Alger Hiss, when another guy who knew said, no, let me tell you who he is. I know, because I'm on that side. He is a bad, bad guy. Everybody laughed it off because Alger Hiss had so much power and influence. Yep. The State Department continued to laugh it off up until Alger Hiss's death. And even when he died, NBC reported not the facts, because we did prove later in life. He was convicted, went to prison, and proved went to prison. And even after death, that's the only time that the State Department came out and said, yes, and we knew at the time. But NBC, when they reported his death, Tom Brokaw came on and said, a guy who a lot of people believed was an agent for the Soviet Union. He went to prison for it. And they're still trying to cover those tracks. So those agents of influence have been with us forever. It's not a new deal.
And we know from the Venona transcripts, yes. which were released in the 90s, how deep the U.S. intelligence agencies knew the penetration was. And we know from some of the terrorism trials, like the Holy Land Foundation trial, the United States government knows how deep the penetration of these Islamist organizations are into our own government right now. I mean, we have the absolutely bizarre situation of the Department of Justice going into federal court saying these organizations and individuals are bad guys, leaving federal court, going to an outreach meeting, putting their arms around the same organizations and individuals and saying these are our outreach partners. I mean, that's how utterly insane it is.
And that's what's so disturbing about this whole thing to me, because we know the Democrats are lost to us. I mean, they've been radicalized, infiltrated. Who knows what all has happened to the Democrat Party? But here we have a guy, a big time conservative operative who everybody thinks is just the small government, lower tax guy, bouncing around in conservative circles and really influencing people all over the place, who also then influence other people and have influence at the highest levels of government. How do you get the American people to understand who he is? Because we've known a lot of these connections for a long time, and nothing ever sticks to it.
They're always dismissed.
They're always just dismissed. How do you get the American people,
Joe,
to stand up and recognize what's going on here?
Well, what I try to do when I talk around the country is I try to sort of resonates with the American people, in my experience, is sort of American first things. You know, you talk about the Constitution, you talk about the First Amendment, you talk about the fact that Americans will literally die for religious liberty. So that's, we're not out to get some religious sect.
Right.
That's exactly the opposite of what we're out to.
Yeah.
And you just try to bring home the issues and the facts. I think the American people are frankly very good at recognizing facts when they see them.
Yes.
The problem is, and this is classic military strategy. If you were trying to engage in a civilization jihad, as the North American Muslim Brotherhood explanatory memorandum says, that is what their plan is. You would want to infiltrate the Republicans at this time more than you'd want to infiltrate the Democrats.
Yes.
Because that's how you're more effective.
So and I've only got about 2 minutes. How is Karl Rove connected to this? I mean, $26 million from Crossroads going to the American tax reform. Karl Rove was there the whole time. He had to know. These guys aren't stupid. So they know who they are being brought into the White House.
We have pictures of Karl Rove at the Texas governor's mansion with some of these characters.
Right. After they were on the speech, given the speech of, hey, who's with Hamas? Who's with Hezbollah? And it has been exposed. So after that happens, they all know. What role does Karl Rove play in this? What role? How much does the GOP know?
I think the establishment GOP doesn't want to know, because they know they lift up they lift up that lid and then suddenly
does that include Karl Rove, or is he a knowing participant in this?
Well, I don't know. You know, certainly we know that he's participated in it. It's been reported in a number of times that Rove took these meetings with these extremists that Grover was bringing
in. So it's just a convenient lie to themselves that if they don't know, they have every reason to know. It's all around them. It's not like we're informing them. It's just a convenient. They're just dismissing it because they get a lot of money from these guys.
And it's precisely that attitude that really has us in the position we are, particularly with respect to our foreign policy, where we are.
It's interest over principles.
Yeah.
Their interest is the money and a win. And their principles would say, no, you can't do this with these guys.
Well, stated differently, Glenn, it's very, very important second things over first things.
Yes.
C.S. Lewis coined this principle. It says, if you're always focusing on second things, classic second things are money and survival. But if that's what you're always focusing on and you're ignoring your first things, those core values that you'd literally die for, in the end, you don't achieve your second things, you don't get the money, and you lose the first things in the process. So
that's where we are.
Karl Rove may be a great money guy, and that's very, very important as part of the overall equation. But we have to focus also on things other than money if in the end we're going to succeed.
And that is, boy, that really explains everything in the GOP. They're only concerned about second things. They're only concerned about winning and money and power, and they're not concerned. And the American people are. The American people are concerned about first things because we know we're about to lose everything. And it's the first things that made us who we are. And if we lose the first things, we're done.
Yep.
We're done. Sponsor this half hour is LifeLock. Man arrested with hundreds of identity pleads guilty. I love this. Guy is driving down the street. Cop stops him. He's in Florida. He says, can I see your ID? He opens up the glove box and he's got ID. He's got 34 debit cards. He has 300 sets of personal ID, all saying he's a different person. They haul him in. They go through his house. They find another additional 100 sets of ID on computers and cell phones that they discovered during the search. He ends up with 55 years in prison. Now, how long did he get away with this before he was pulled over by a cop and made the accident of, oh, hang on, which ID do you want, officer? Everything about us is connected, our bank records, and it's stored on a cloud. There was a story in the newspaper I read today that the cloud is the problem. That is the breach of security. Once you're connected to the cloud, it's over. Nobody can monitor all the transactions in every business, but LifeLock Ultimate Plus is comprehensive identity theft protection. Visit LifeLock.com/Beck and use the promo code Beck and save 10% on your LifeLock Ultimate Plus membership. 1-800-440-4936. 1-800-440-4936. LifeLock.com/Beck.
Got something to say?
888-727-BECK.
Dial in.
Hello? Go ahead.
And let it out. The Blaze Radio Network.
Let me talk to you for a minute. If you run a business, especially if you're hiring, it used to be that you would post a job in one place and hope for the best, but that's not nearly enough to find the right qualified candidates now. If you want to find the best perfect hire, you need to post the job on all of the top websites with ZipRecruiter.com. You can post your job to 50-plus job sites, including social networks like Facebook and Twitter, all with a single click. Find candidates in any industry, just one post, and watch your qualified candidates roll in to ZipRecruiter's easy-to-use interface. And with ZipRecruiter's premium traffic boost, you can get up to 3 times more candidates. Quickly screen applicants, rate them, and hire the right person fast. Find out why ZipRecruiter has been used by over 200,000 businesses already. And right now, you can try it for free. Plus, get 30% off your first traffic boost by going to ZipRecruiter.com/Beck. That's ZipRecruiter.com/Beck. Go to ZipRecruiter.com/Beck.
Good credits, bad credits. It's none of our business because we're not an auto dealer. We're not a bank. We're not your mother. We're OcalaForSale.com. Marion County's marketplace for cars, trucks, and SUVs. We've got thousands of sellers standing by to take your call. No middleman. But hurry, don't walk, don't run. Just sit down and log on to OcalaForSale.com.
Prices and inventory change daily. Offer does not include dealer upcharge. Undercutting, rust proofing, factory surcharge, or delivery fee. See website for details.
Gene Powell Pass Des Moines. Our tractor services include bush hog, disking, front end loader, box blade, and stump grinding. We also have zero turn mowers for the smaller paddocks, aisleways, fence rows, and lawn care. Fence row spraying is also available for weed control. We are licensed and insured. Gene Powell Pass Des Moines, 352-629-2440 or online at PowellGene, G-E-N-E, at yahoo.com. Gene Powell Pass Des Moines.
It's the end of the fiscal year, and that means budget cuts and number crunching. Now's the time of the year you're evaluating your expenses, planning your budget, and finding ways to save money and increase efficiency to maximize profits. Dex Imaging understands and delivers. Call Dex Imaging today for a free document management evaluation. Cutting your office expenses is as easy as calling Dex Imaging, 352-266-0333. Start saving money today and increase your bottom line with Dex Imaging. Printers, copiers, and fax machines that increase office productivity and save you money. No one understands your bottom line better. Call Dex Imaging today, 352-266-0333, or check them out on the web at DexImaging.com. That's DexImaging.com, or call 352-266-0333 for your free document management evaluation today.
Black Cow Composted Cow Manure is a terrific organic soil amendment. We start with cow manure from dairy farms and then compost it a full 90 days. The result is an all-natural, dark, rich soil amendment that's great for everything you grow. Flowers, vegetables, shrubs, trees, and lawns too. Look for Black Cow in the bright yellow and black bag at your favorite nursery or garden center.
Black Cow, the mature manure. Black Cow.
Buried under receipts and confusing tax code? Let Crippen & Company help. They work hard to make the tax preparation process as painless as possible. With offices in Ocala and the Villages, their team is dedicated to helping clients with corporate and personal tax returns, bookkeeping for businesses, and estate planning for the future. Crippen & Company crafts a truly customized experience for each client's needs while alleviating stress and creating a big picture of your overall financial health. Call 352-732-4260 or visit crippencpa.com to get started.
Glenn Beck Program.
I want to thank Joe Schmitz and Patrick Poole for being a part of the program today. They're going to be joining us tonight. You don't want to miss it. We'll have extra coverage on theblaze.com. And if you want to see this Grover episode tonight, it is free. Theblaze.com/Grover. You can watch it for free.
Don't miss a morsel of truth. Sign up for the free newsletter at glenbeck.com. The Glenn Beck program returns in minutes.
The Blaze Radio Network.
Look around your office right now. Look at the 10 people closest to you. One of them has dropped their iPhone into the toilet. About 10% of people who have iPhones have actually dropped them into the toilet. Get off the phone when you're on at the toilet.
No, you know how it happens?
No.
I don't mean to be graphic, but you take your pants down, you got it in your back pocket, and it flips out of your
back pocket. This is what happened to your wife's ring.
There's
too,
your one in ten.
Yeah, there you go. Glenn is the one. Okay, you can actually get your phone, you know, get the toilet, and it's not working anymore. You can actually get it repaired if you have insurance. SquareTrade is the place to get this. It costs less than half of what the other guys charge you, and the deductible is much less as well. Don't deal with a phone that's been in the toilet. Do the smart thing and protect your new iPhone, Galaxy, or any smartphone with SquareTrade. It's only $5 a month. Visit SquareTrade.com. That's SquareTrade.com. SquareTrade.com.
Goldline has been innovating the process of buying gold for more than 50 years. Only at Goldline can you get unprecedented price protection programs for qualified purchases of $10,000 or more. And now with their special accumulation program, you can begin acquiring exclusive bullion coins for as little as $100 a month. Goldline truly makes it easy for anyone to own physical gold or silver. Don't wait. With the craziness in the world and our economy, what are you waiting for? Call Goldline today and receive your free investor kit, 1-866-GOLDLINE. They're the only precious metal company that I trust and recommend, 866-465-3546. Ask them about the payment options and read their important risk information to see if buying precious metals is right for you. They'll also include your free copy of the latest Precious Metals Insider, which is full of useful information about gold and silver markets. At Goldline, credit card orders receive the same price as cash, and shipping is always free. Call Goldline today, 866-GOLDLINE, or Gold.
That was the sound of a tree falling. It could be your tree. You're going to have it trimmed, but never got around to calling Pride Tree Service. It could have fallen in a field, and now all you have to do is call Pride Tree Service, and they'll have it quickly out of the way for a great price. But don't wait until the tree falls. It may not fall in the field. It may hit your car, your house, or worse. So call Pride Tree Service today and avoid all those headaches before they happen. Pride Tree Service, 840-0750. That's 840-0750.
Here's what you may have missed on the John Tesh Radio Show.
In a study involving more than 2,000 people, those with slimmer waistlines showed higher cognitive ability than those who were overweight or obese. Our pets improve our character and make us much better people. If your partner's the one who's stressed out, we know that you will be 25% more likely to be affected than a stranger would be. Yeah, be careful, because stress is contagious.
Intelligence for your life on the John Tesh Radio Show. Don't miss this stuff.
Broadcasting from the Paddock Mall Studios, this is WOCA, Ocala, Gainesville, The Villages, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, The Source.
Fox News Radio, I'm Lillian Wu. He's not on any sort of terror watch list or known to law enforcement officials for any reason. Yet German Wings co-pilot Andreas Lubitz is said to have deliberately crashed the plane, killing all 150 on board.
Germany's Chancellor Angela Merkel saying it's an absolutely unimaginable development. Prosecutors say a recording shows the pilot locked out of the cockpit, desperately trying to get back in. But all the while, Lubitz is steering the plane towards the ground.
Fox Radio Simon Owen, a state of emergency declared for dozens of Oklahoma counties after powerful storms ripped through, leaving at least one dead.
Schools are closed in Tulsa and more, where one school's roof was ripped off.
There's been quite a few injuries in Tulsa.
Governor Mary Fallon, tens of thousands remain without power.
Fox Radio's Jeff Manasso, and emergency crews in Central Texas responding to a report of a bridge collapse along an interstate. Fox News, we report, you decide.
I'm Lex Friedman. I run my own business, so I know from experience, hiring new employees can be tough. Posting your job in one place isn't enough to find quality candidates. If you want to find the perfect hire, you need to post your job on all the top job sites. And now you can with ZipRecruiter.com. You can post your job to 50-plus job sites, including social networks like Facebook and Twitter, all with a single click. Find candidates in any industry nationwide. Just post once and watch your qualified candidates roll in to ZipRecruiter's easy-to-use interface. And with ZipRecruiter's premium traffic boost, you can get up to 3 times more candidates. Quickly screen applicants, rate them, and hire the right person fast. Find out why ZipRecruiter has been used by over 200,000 businesses. Right now, our listeners can try ZipRecruiter for free. Plus, get 30% off your first traffic boost by going to ZipRecruiter.com/info. That's ZipRecruiter.com/info. One more time, to try it for free, go to ZipRecruiter.com/info.
On the next AM Ocala Live, Robin and I will be speaking to Jim George. You know him better as Professor Gadget. He's the owner of American Cable Services, and he helps us understand all of this confusing technology.
News Bites, the hottest news and current events are bite-sized.
And then Kelly Hart will be in the studio bringing you her program, Ocala Magazine Radio.
Tom Krotler is the co-host of The Money Pit. He'll be speaking about do-it-yourself projects for spring, outdoor living, garages, and showcasing your lawn.
Dr. Thomas Campbell is coming on. He's an instructor of clinical family medicine at the University of Rochester School of Medicine and Dentistry, and he's written a book. It's called The Campbell Plan, The Simple Way to Lose Weight and Reverse Illness.
Dr. Tim Conway is a clinical psychologist with a concentration in neuropsychology. He will be in the studio speaking about his Kiss the Horse 2015 fundraising event for the Marion County Literacy Council.
All of that plus fun with Joe on the next AM Ocala Live right here on The Source, WOCA 96.3 FM.
1378.
Here's what you may have missed on the John Tesh Radio Show.
In a study involving more than 2,000 people, those with slimmer waistlines showed higher cognitive ability than those who were overweight or obese. Our pets improve our character and make us much better people. If your partner's the one who's stressed out, we know that you will be 25% more likely to be affected than a stranger would be. Yeah, be careful, because stress is contagious.
Intelligence for your life on the John Tesh Radio Show. Don't miss this stuff.
Hey, I'm Gary.
And I'm Eric. Did you know that Red Eye Radio is on WOCA The Source every night from 2 to 6 a.m. and it's live?
That's right. No tape shows here.
We know that the news doesn't sleep.
And neither do we. So we're here with you live from 2 till 6 a.m. every weekday. Call us 866-90-RED-EYE. So join me, Gary McNamara.
And me, Eric Harley, every weeknight to discuss the latest in news and entertainment.
Right here on WOCA The Source.
Hey, Matt, I know Sunrise Automotive does auto stuff, but I need some tires for my truck. Can you recommend someone?
Yes, I can. We do that.
No, I mean, I need them installed and balanced and all that.
Yep, we do that.
Well, my son needed his windows tinted.
Yep, we do that.
I need my seat replaced.
Yep, we do that too.
I need a new roofline and a new spoiler and a new truck.
Yep, we can even do that too.
Okay, I get it. I suppose you can also do a radio show too, huh?
Well, as a matter of fact, join me every Monday at 10 for auto repair with personal care here on The Source.
Of course you do.
Good credits, bad credits. It's none of our business, because we're not an auto dealer. We're not a bank. We're not your mother. We're OcalaForSale.com, Marion County's marketplace for cars, trucks, and SUVs. We've got thousands of sellers standing by to take your call. No middleman. But hurry, don't walk, don't run. Just sit down and log on to OcalaForSale.com.
Prices and inventory change daily. Offer does not include dealer upcharge. Undercutting, rust proofing, factory surcharge, or delivery fee. See website for details.
Do you have areas that have started sagging or drooping? Is what you're looking at not quite the same as it was years ago? Are there enhancements you've been putting off? Is there serious damage you need fixed? Then call on us, Damage Control Services. When your roof is sagging and the drywall is drooping after a storm, or your home just needs some enhancements, from damage repairs to new construction, Damage Control Services is here to help.
Hi, I'm Leah Caruso with Strive Rehabilitation, inviting you to join me Thursday at 11 a.m. for Health Matters. Ocala Health and Strive have teamed up to bring you the latest information on good health services available to you right here at home. This vital information will help you make informed decisions about your health. So don't forget to join me here at 11 a.m. Thursday. It's news you can use from Ocala Health, Strive, and your friends here at WOCA.
You're listening to WOCA, Ocala.
about to hear is the fusion of entertainment and enlightenment. This is the Glenn Beck Program.
I'm fascinated to hear Grover Norquist tonight. He canceled last night. I got a note while I was on the air last night and laying out the case against him that he didn't want to be on the television show. It was too small for him. So we said, that's fine. We released the exchange of email on Facebook and on The Blaze. And then this morning at 6:38, after we had flown other people in to do the show, he decided he does want to be on the
TV that's
show.
Not what we meant at all. I don't know how you got that out of.
We didn't mean that at all.
No.
So he's going to be on with us tonight. I'm making this episode free. It's theblaze.com/Grover if you want to see that. You really should watch last night's episode. To see all of the facts and who these people are. I mean, it is a devastating case. Pat,
it's like Porky's too. You don't want to watch it until you've seen Porky's one.
Yeah, right.
You know, you won't understand the subtle nuances.
Pat was saying this morning it was like watching the Van Jones era on Fox and the Tides Foundation.
Oh yeah, that whole Soros thing where you showed all the connections there. Same thing.
I will say this: it was like the first time that we started to talk about Van Jones, and I got up the chalkboard. In another couple of weeks, I'm going to have this thing so down, and we're going to have so many magnets on the board and everything else just the way. I mean, I'll be able to really zero in because, as Pat and I were talking, there's something to this. There's something much, much greater to this, and I'm just getting a sense of it now. This explains.
As we go through the news of the day.
Yeah.
We start to think, okay, that makes more sense.
Yes, it does.
All right, that makes a lot more sense. And yeah, everything starts falling into place.
Do you remember when we first started on the progressive thing and everybody thought this was no big deal? And once we understood the progressive history and we knew the connections with the president and the Tides Foundation, you were like, oh my gosh, I see exactly what they're doing. Mm-hmm. I understand why the news is what the news is. It makes sense. You're going to understand the GOP. And you're going to understand why we pussyfoot around. You're going to understand all of that.
Because you remember before we understood progressivism, we were always like,
how did
this happen?
What is happening?
How is this possible?
Now we get it.
And then it all fell into place.
Now that we
Same thing's happening with this Muslim Brotherhood situation.
Yeah, when you start pulling the string of Grover Norquist, you're going to start to understand the Muslim Brotherhood. You're going to understand why people are saying what they say about, you know, why we're releasing people. Well, let me just go through the news of the day. Give me the two stories here, Pat. Let's do
Bo Bergdahl.
Bergdahl first.
U.S. soldier who slipped away from his base in the middle of the night. And then we went out. He was gone for 4.5 years, something like that. And then we got him back by sending them five
really bad terrorists. Guys.
We got on the battlefield, exchanged them for one guy who had deserted his unit. Well, he's now been charged with desertion.
Yeah. Now, they said the Obama administration said this at the time.
He served the United States with honor and distinction.
No, he deserted.
He served the United States with honor and distinction.
No, soldiers actually lost their lives trying to save him.
He served the United States with honor and distinction.
No, he actually, we traded five battle-hardened bad guys from Gitmo for a dirtbag that deserted.
No,
he served the United States with honor and distinction.
Yeah.
He served the United States with honor and distinction.
No, he didn't. Okay, so why did they do that? Why did they do that? You'll begin to understand that. Now, the other story that we have today.
Josh Earnest, at his daily press conference yesterday, was pressed again by the same guy we're always talking about, who the only one who does his job as a journalist, John Carl. John Carl sees the total collapse of the government in Yemen. And it puts that together with, hey, the administration has been telling us that Yemen is a model for how we should be conducting counterterrorism.
Okay, now I want you to understand. Listen to that carefully. The administration continues to say that Yemen is a model for how we should conduct our national security and our fight against terror. You couple that information with they continue to say that with the fact that the Yemeni government has collapsed and the president is now in exile.
Yeah, he fled the country.
So there is no more government. There's no government structure at all in Yemen. And John Carl wants to ask this question.
Now that we have, you know, essentially complete chaos in Yemen,
does the White House still believe that Yemen is the model for counterterrorism?
Stop. I just want you to, again, before you hear the White House response, there is no government. It has collapsed under the pressure of Islamic terror.
Right.
There is no government.
The
president is
out of
gone.
Town. He's out
the
of,
country
out of country.
Is complete chaos. Listen to the White House response.
John, the White House does continue to believe that a successful counterterrorism strategy is one that will build up the capacity of the central government.
Okay. There's no central government.
Right. Have local fighters on the ground take the fight to extremists in their own country.
That's not happened.
Sadly, what happened was the local rebels took the fight to the central government and collapsed it.
Collapsed it. Killed it. Okay. They lost. The central government lost to the terrorists.
That is a template that has...
But it's
succeeded in mitigating the threat that we face from extremists in places like Yemen and Somalia.
Okay, stop for a second. So the government, our government, our White House sees what the Yemeni government, which no longer exists, as a template for how we should behave.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a template that we believe can succeed in mitigating the threat emanating from Syria.
Listen
as well.
To this.
It's astounding. You're saying that you still see Yemen as the model? I mean, the central building up the central government which has now collapsed, a president who has apparently fled the country, Saudi troops amassing on one border, the Iranians supporting the rebels. Mm-hmm. You consider this is a model for counterterrorism?
I love this guy because... How is that not the question on every reporter in that room's lips? How is he the only one that this has occurred to?
No, this is like a parallel universe. It's like John Carl has slipped through a wormhole and is in a parallel universe where up is down and down is up. And he's like, this is absurd.
And I don't think John Carl's a conservative guy.
No, he's not.
He's not a Republican. He wouldn't agree with us on much, I'm guessing. But he's doing his job because...
It's
they don't
insane.
Make sense.
It's insane. It doesn't make any sense.
Again, John, what the United States considers to be our strategy when confronting the effort to try to mitigate the threat that is posed by extremists is to prevent them from establishing a safe haven.
Yeah,
and
but
certainly
you,
in a
you
chaotic,
hey, stop,
dangerous
stop,
situation.
Stop. Okay, so. They have all of Yemen now. They have their safe haven. His strategy didn't work. Let's not use that strategy in Syria with ISIS. And that's what he's talking about.
Right.
We're going to use this. This is the strategy we're using in Syria. It's almost like you don't want the Bashar Assad regime to survive in Syria if this is your template.
No. It's almost like that, but
it can't be.
It can't be that.
Right. Like in Yemen, what the United States will do and has done is worked to try to support the central government, to build up the capacity of local fighters.
And you can't now because there is no central government.
There was a famous guy who once said,
No, try not, do or do not. There is no try. Yes.
Use our own technological and military capabilities to apply pressure on the extremists there.
I just want to make this clear.
Putting a lot
they're
of
going
on
to
them.
Continue to use the central government, which doesn't exist, to apply pressure to the terrorists
who do exist,
so they don't get a safe haven, which they now have called the entire country of Yemen.
Uh huh.
It's just a template.
It's a good template, too.
We'd like to see a functioning central government in Yemen. We don't see that.
Stop.
Right?
There's
we'd
a
like
good
to
one.
See it. We don't
we'd
see
like
it.
We'd like to see one.
Thank you.
Like we had one. We'd like to see a functioning central government.
I'd also like to see monkeys fly out his butt, but I never see that.
Right. That's a lofty goal. I don't know. We're setting the standard pretty high.
The former leader that fled the country, he would like to see that.
He'd
as well.
Like to
yes,
see one, too.
He would, but he doesn't see that.
Wonder how he feels about this template that the United States is using.
Now. And that is why we're supportive of the UN-led process to try to put an end to the violence and instability to bring the sides, all sides
stopped,
together.
Stop! He should have started.
Our effort didn't work, but we're supportive of the UN's effort.
You should have led with that.
Yeah.
Oh, we got the blue helmets. We're following the blue helmets because they fix everything.
They're fierce.
Okay.
That's incredible.
Okay. So here's how this thing is all going to go down. Grover Norquist is coming on the show tonight at 5 o'clock. I laid the case out last night, and it's damning. It is really damning. There's no way. I mean, I sat with a bunch of people, really smart people, this morning, and I said, what is he going to say? I can't imagine his answers. What is he going to say?
Other than you're a racist, you're a bigot.
Correct.
You know, this is Frank Gaffney's
vendetta. This is old news.
All of that stuff.
Right.
All the deflecting.
And none of that is... I will end the interview in five minutes. If that's the game he's going to play, it's over.
Yeah.
There's no reason. I'm not going
to
waste an hour
it's
of your time.
Business. It's just business to him, right? Meet and greet, money, hello. We met. We didn't know what was going on.
But here's a guy who went to Harvard. I mean, this is not a stupid guy. When he finds out about Alamudi, as somebody said to me today, do you check your sock drawer to see if there are holes in other socks? Or are you just like, nah, it's just that one sock. No need to check anything else. What are you doing? He's not a stupid guy. So how does a really smart guy come on this show? I mean, nobody had the balls to do that. We invited Van Jones, but nobody had the balls to do that. What the hell does he have? How is he going to explain this nightmare?
And if there were a magic bullet to where he could explain it all away in a logical and reasonable way.
He would have done it 15 years ago.
But if he still had one now, wouldn't you be? I'd be happy about that.
Oh, I'd be thrilled.
I got nothing against
Grover Norquist. I don't want another problem on our plate.
I don't care. But what the problem is now, you look at all these associations, you see the connections, and you start to think, well, this is starting to make a lot of sense. This is why they'll exchange five Taliban terrorists for one deserter. This is why they won't use the word Islam when describing extreme
terrorists.
Which
started during the Bush administration.
And that's when the influence was happening with Grover Norquist as well.
This is why...
And it's just carried over now into the Obama administration.
This is why we don't look into the Saudi Arabian connections.
You can't check the other socks in the drawer.
Correct. It's too much money. You can't. No, it's exactly right.
Right.
And it's all about interest and not principles.
And it's why we're using the same template that doesn't obviously work. The one in Yemen.
Yeah.
Yemen and Somalia. Mm-hmm. Are you telling me Somalia is in good shape too?
Because we're being guided by the Muslim Brotherhood. Zudi Jasser said 95% of all of the Islamic institutes here in America, 95% are Muslim Brotherhood front groups.
Do you have a single doubt that's true? I don't.
It explains why we haven't shut down that mosque in Boston.
Right.
We knew about it under the Bush administration. The Bush administration did nothing. Because Grover Norquist's partner, the guy who helped give him the money to start the Islamic Institute, founded the Islamic Society of Boston. The guy who's sitting in prison. The guy who says Hamas and Hezbollah, I'm one with those guys. After Grover Norquist finds out who he is, he sets him up on a plane with Khalid Safouri and his other number two guy from Grover Norquist's other number two guy, sends him on a plane to go meet with the Bushes. During the transition team, he sends him down to have pictures taken. He knows who these guys are. They've already announced it. So why is he sending him down there? It doesn't make any sense at all. Why did we not go into the Islamic Society of Boston? Why do we turn a blind eye? Why did John McCain go over to Syria, meet with really bad Muslim guys that we know are terrorists, and we have pictures of John McCain with terrorists, and John McCain says, hey, you can't vet everybody. I didn't know everybody. At first, he says, they're not terrorists. I know who these guys are. Then he says, oh, I can't. Why? Because John McCain is part of this kind of group. The GOP has been infected by Grover Norquist And I bet you...
And no question, others.
And others. And when we start, when we really... You give me a month with this chalkboard, I'm going to have so many damn connections. You watch. We're going in full-fledged Tides Foundation mode. We're going back to the way we were at Fox on this because something is really wrong. And this goes to the center of the core of why the GOP is rotten from the core. Because they only care about money. That's why Karl Rove is involved. Mm-hmm. Karl Rove gave Grover Norquist $26 million.
Oh, that was just for the tax reform fund. That's all.
I'm sorry,
taxes.
Man. Hey, Pat. Do you give a dime to somebody who is like really good? Hey, I'm doing some charity work over here, and I'm helping, you know, sick kids with no eyes.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Oh, also.
I agree with helping them.
You agree.
That's okay. A good thing.
You give me a check for that?
Yes.
Okay. You still give me a check if I'm also part of the Italian mafia and I'm slaughtering people at night, completely separate from the charity.
How many people?
Lots.
Lots.
Not willingly.
You're giving the money willingly. To...
Absolutely not.
No, you're not. No. You're not doing it.
No, you're not.
So what is Grover getting $26 million from Karl Rove? Because Karl Rove was there at the White House when all of these people were lined up for pictures.
Mm-hmm.
He knows. This explains everything.
Really does.
You want to know why we're not winning the war? You want to know why we're not fighting it? You want to know why we're so PC? You want to know why the Islamic Brotherhood is a largely secular group and everybody stands around and goes, yeah, that's true. When the president of Egypt says there's a problem with the Muslim Brotherhood and we have to shut down 26,000 mosques? When Saudi Arabia and UAE...
25% of everything in the country, by the way.
When the UAE and Saudi Arabia and everybody else says Muslim Brotherhood is a terrorist group, and we're saying that they're largely secular and they have Muslim in the name, you want to know why? Grover Norquist. Watch the show tonight. He'll be appearing with us tonight, and it's free. Go to theblaze.com/Grover, and you'll see that episode free tonight, 5 p.m. Eastern time. Blinds.com is our sponsor this half hour. Jumpstart your spring cleaning by refreshing your old musty window treatments with beautiful new blind shades or drapes. There's no better way to revitalize the room that's been bugging you all winter than a quick window treatment covering and an update from Blinds.com. It's an easy and budget-friendly way to refresh a room, no matter your do-it-yourself prowess. Do it yourself and save big bucks in about 20 minutes. That's all you need to give your home a spring makeover with designer window coverings by yourself. They're free, easy how-to videos. Make free expert advice with the free expert advice. Make everything really, really simple. And if you mismeasure, which is unlikely, they'll remake it for you for free. Catch the first glimpse of springtime through beautiful shutters from Blinds.com. You'll love the view no matter the season. Save 25% off the top-selling window treatments all month long at Blinds.com. From blinds, shades, to draperies, Blinds.com. They've got you covered and your windows covered this March. As always, get free color samples, free shipping, free expert advice, and prices that crush the prices you find at stores. It's Blinds.com.
This is the Glenn Beck Program.
The Blaze Radio Network.
The Smarter Way to Manage Business Expenses, presented by Concur.
After my conference, I checked out of the hotel and the bill was automatically added to my expense report. Then I hopped into a taxi. I snapped a photo of the receipt using Concur and bam, there it was on my expense report. Then I used my corporate card to buy the client's lunch. Another charge added to my expense report.
Expense reports that write themselves. Just one of the many ways Concur helps manage your company's spend so you can focus on the big picture. Take a free test drive today at tryconcur.com.
I'm Chris Walls. Since taking Andro 400, I have dropped 45 pounds. I'm sleeping better. My knee pain went away. I've had some lower back issues, and I've noticed that went away. The radio ad says it attacks belly fat. Well, let me tell you, it did. I've lost 6 inches.
So, guys, if you'd like to get similar results, try Andro 400, the safe, inexpensive way to boost your testosterone. Go to andro400.com or call 866-546-1955. 866-546-1955.
Hi, I'm Seth with AA Lock, Dock, and Security. Have you ever thought about the locks or security on your house or business? Have you ever wondered why the keys to your new car cost so much? Well, at AA Lock, Dock, and Security, we can help with securing your valuables. We can even replace those expensive transponder keys. We can give you the knowledge that no one else will. Call AA Lock, Dock, and Security at 867-1965. That's 867-1965.
Your weekends are getting a little retooled.
Swear to God, not making a joke.
Check this out.
New shows?
Check.
We are Buzzworks.
Some new talent?
Check.
Let's welcome the guys.
Let's get it going.
Arnie Spanier.
Unbelievable.
TJ Reeves.
This is what you get.
Your weekends are on fire.
Because that's how exotic it is.
We are Buzzworks.
Get it for less at the DIY Home Center Outlet. Get top quality real wood cabinets the same or less than the big box stores are selling the cheap stuff. And that's not all. Drywall screws big box stores are $6.47 a pound. At DIY, only $4.99. Plus, DIY has the largest selection of mobile home parts and accessories anywhere. From carpet to doors, get the DIY supplies you need for less. The DIY Home Center Outlet. We are your building material closeout store. 2191 Northwest 10th Street, just 2 miles east of I-75.
One of the most common questions those nearing retirement are asking, will I outlive my money? Retirement questions like these and many more will be answered every Saturday morning at 9 a.m. on Planning for a Better and Safer Retirement with hosts Francois and Julian Cozenet. Francois and Julian will help you put your retirement puzzle together. Catch Planning for a Better and Safer Retirement Saturdays at 9 a.m. on Ocala's News Talk, The Source, 96.3 FM and 1370 AM.
Program returns. Have we ever done an interview like this tonight?
I don't think so.
I don't think so either.
And I will say, I respect him for at least coming on.
Yes, absolutely.
Right? Nobody faces the fire. Van Jones certainly didn't. And all we wanted were answers as to why you hired a communist revolutionary in the White House
that's
in the first place. That's all we wanted.
That's all we wanted.
Never got it, but wanted. That's all we wanted. All we want from Grover is, why are you cozying up to Muslim Brotherhood?
Terrorist. Why? That's all we want.
That's all we want. Just tell us why.
What is it, so bad? Okay, we have a difference of opinion. I say terrorism is bad. You say, hey, I like their money. What? What could be so wrong?
Gonna be a good show.
See his answer.
You're
tonight at 5.
Listening to the Glenn Beck Program, the Blaze Radio Network.
Fox News Radio. I'm Lillian Wu. He's not on any sort of terror watch list or known to law enforcement officials for any reason. Yet German Wings co-pilot Andreas Lubitz is said to have deliberately crashed the plane, killing all 150 on board.
Germany's Chancellor Angela Merkel saying it's an absolutely unimaginable development. Prosecutors say a recording shows the pilot locked out of the cockpit, desperately trying to get back in. But all the while, Lubitz is steering the plane towards the ground.
Fox Radio Simon Owen, a state of emergency declared for dozens of Oklahoma counties after powerful storms ripped through, leaving at least one dead.
Schools are closed in Tulsa and more where one school's roof was ripped off.
There's been quite a few injuries in Tulsa.
Governor Mary Fallon, tens of thousands remain without power.
Fox Radio's Jeff Manasso, an emergency crews in Central Texas responding to a report of a bridge collapse along an interstate. Fox News, we report, you decide.
I'm Lex Friedman. I run my own business, so I know from experience, hiring new employees can be tough. Posting your job in one place isn't enough to find quality candidates. If you want to find the perfect hire, you need to post your job on all the top job sites. And now you can, with ZipRecruiter.com. You can post your job to 50-plus job sites, including social networks like Facebook and Twitter, all with a single click. Find candidates in any industry nationwide. Just post once and watch your qualified candidates roll in to ZipRecruiter's easy-to-use interface. And with ZipRecruiter's premium traffic boost, you can get up to 3 times more candidates. quickly screen applicants, rate them, and hire the right person fast. Find out why ZipRecruiter has been used by over 200,000 businesses. Right now, our listeners can try ZipRecruiter for free. Plus, get 30% off your first traffic boost by going to ZipRecruiter.com/info. That's ZipRecruiter.com/info. One more time. To try it for free, go to ZipRecruiter.com/info.
Chip, you never cease to amaze me. What in the world are you building with all those sticks and cardboard?
Well, Mr. Marketing Guy, I'm making signs to announce the great lease offers at Ford Lincoln of Ocala and Village Ford of Bellevue.
Really? What do you plan on calling it?
Sign and Ride. Get it?
That's not how it works. Sign and Ride is all about fantastic lease offers on Fusions, Escapes, Fiestas, Explorers, and remaining 2014 Focuses.
Wait a minute. If I understand correctly, Sign and Ride would mean zero down payment?
Right.
Zero first month's payment.
Right again.
And zero due at signing?
Now you're on the right track. Don't waste time. Head to Ford Lincoln of Ocala and Village Ford of Bellevue today and see how easy it can be to drive off in America's favorite brand.
And if you're planning to buy a new Ford, 0% financing for 72 months on select new 2015 Fords.
Whether you buy or lease, now's the best time to head to Ford Lincoln of Ocala or Village Ford of Bellevue, your family of Ford dealerships where we've got what it takes.
Not all buyers or models qualify for sign and ride offer or 0% financing. See dealer for complete details.
Much like the weather, your life could change at the drop of a hat. Don't be caught unprepared. You don't know what'll happen tomorrow, but no matter what happens, you can make sure that your loved ones are provided for with a life insurance policy from Auto Owners Insurance. Meet with a local independent agent and secure a policy now to rest easy, knowing you're protecting the ones you love. Visit George Mangan Insurance in Ocala today at www.manganinsurance.com.
Hi, Danny Werfel here. Get moving with Florida Credit Union's fast and easy loan approval process.
Let Florida Credit Union start up a new car loan for you today. No more waiting, hassles, or stop signs. You can even apply online. With a strong financial team behind you, you can enjoy great rates and fast approvals.
It's all about personalized service and a streamlined process.
Florida Credit Union, connecting your money to your life.
Real estate is the largest and most personal investment that any of us will ever make. Be sure to tune in Tuesdays at 10 a.m. when Bob Kennedy, owner of Berkshire Hathaway Home Team Realty, will be answering your questions and discussing real estate. So remember, that's Tuesdays at 10 a.m. Call 622-9622 with your questions. It pays to be an informed buyer or seller. This is news you can use from Berkshire Hathaway Home Team Realty and your friends here at WOCA.
WOCA.
Your source for the number one sports weekend, Fox Sports, only on 96.3 FM, 1370 AM.
This is WOCA, News Talk 1370.
WOCA.
Is the Glenn Beck program.
Pat and I were just talking in the break about, this is years ago, what, 1990?
Yeah, right around there.
So Pat and I are working together in Baltimore, and Foreigner comes, and this is when it was still the real guys from Foreigner.
Yeah, it was Lou Gramm, Mick Jones.
And they were going to, you know, they're do a little concert for us and stuff, so that we actually, you know, we're kind of somebody. And so Foreigner comes, and Pat always does his impression of Foreigner. And I always thought it was
good.
Great. No, I thought it was always great. It was funny.
It was funny, but.
And so the guys come in, and I was like, oh, you got to hear Pat's impersonation.
I mean, Lou Gramm is standing there, and he's like, oh, you got to hear it. And it's just a screeching. Well, you've heard me sing Happy Days Are Here Again. Yeah. It's sort of like that.
But when you hear him sing it with Foreigner in the studio for years,
you're like,
oh, you laugh.
That's kind of close.
You're like, that's great.
A lot of times funny isn't good.
Yeah, right.
Yes. No, these guys would have had a good sense of humor.
Yeah.
And that's what I thought at the time. And so I said, no, you got to hear it. Now we're on the air.
And so Pat's like, no, I'm not gonna.
It's not good. It's really like, not good.
No,
Lou.
It's good. It's
and
funny.
So,
it's
so
good.
Glenn says it so many times that Lou Gramm finally says, I just as a concession to move along the interview. Okay. Do it.
And so he does it. I'm like, you're gonna love this. Go ahead, Pat. Go. Do feels like the first time.
It feels like the first time. That kind of thing. So it was
so
not well received.
Lou Gramm just looks at him and like, goes,
you think that's what I sound like? No, Lou. But he was pissed the rest of the interview. You couldn't get a word out of him the rest of the time.
Hey, how about some pictures?
Yeah. Everybody that we ever interviewed in music, everybody went away pissed.
Yeah, they did.
Everybody went away
pissed. Some of them started pissed, like Hall & Oates. Daryl Hall, remember that?
Yeah.
Oh, that guy was...
He was like, what? We were thinking, what part of your rock star life has pissed you off?
Yeah, right? I know. And by the way, you guys know it's not 1981 anymore. Yeah, it's like 1990 now.
You really kind of need people like us.
Really
it's that sad. Your career has gone that far off the rails.
Just think how pissed you would be.
Yeah, you're playing a radio studio in Baltimore, Maryland. I don't know. Do you think this was a football stadium?
This is really not.
It's not, guys.
No.
Yeah, so we pissed off as many musicians probably as
we have politicians. I think we're the only people to get yelled at by Tony Bennett.
Oh, my gosh.
Did he? Yeah, he hated our guts.
I forget. Oh, I remember. It was, you tried to get him to sing?
The song, right?
Yeah, I wanted him to sing I Left My Heart in San Francisco. And right. I said it in a way that, you know, the guy is like.
And the reason you said it this way was because so many times we've been burned by these performers like David Cassidy, who you'll say, hey, David, sing
the song I'm most famous for.
I think I love you. He's like, I'm not singing that. I don't. Do that.
Right.
Yeah, there's just these people who have been around forever and they're tired of it. They're tired of it.
They don't want to do
that.
And
so I said, so I can't have Tony Bennett here without asking. And he had an orchestra, had the piano and the orchestra.
He meant it in the most respectful and nice way.
Yeah. I mean, it's Tony Bennett for the love of Pete. And I said, I can't have Tony Bennett here without asking if you would, because he said, do you have any requests? Well, yeah, I can't have you here and not ask you. And you don't have to perform it if you're sick of it or something, but would you play So I Left My Heart in San Francisco? And
why would I be sick of it?
He just went off. Well, he was crazy.
It was weird.
Like, I just went, of course I will sing that song. Why would you think I'm sick of it?
It's a song I'm most famous for. Okay, why would I not want to do that?
Tony. Tony's unstable. Tony's unstable.
Medication.
We almost died at the hand of Tony Bennett.
You should hear his Lou Gramm.
Yes, we've been winning friends and influencing people for 26 years.
So we've moved on from the music industry, and we've gone to politics now, where Karl Rove and Grover Norquist
love us. Glenn, do your Grover Norquist imitation.
Super Grover! I love the Muslim Brotherhood.
Pull its string and it says amazing Grover things.
Let's blow something up. Where's Abdurrahman Alamoudi? I've never met him before. Do you have a check? So, okay. What else is on our list? We only have a couple of minutes left here of the program. Let's see. Oh, we have to play Ted Cruz and his complete takedown. So satisfying. It's almost a romantic moment. Light a candle, put on some soft music, and listen to this takedown of a question on global warming.
Okay, you're going global warming. Yeah. I've got two takedowns here.
Oh, what do you have?
I wasn't sure which way you were going. But we'll do the global warming because I have that.
What if there is something to it? I mean, a lot of people say the science is clear. Most people say the science is clear. But let's say that it's not. Let's say it's not clear. Why not do everything we can to reduce our carbon footprint? Wouldn't that be good to have some humility about it and maybe think?
Can you believe that question, though? Have some humility about it from the people who say the science is settled, the debate is over. People who don't believe as we do are stupid idiots. They're science deniers. We're the ones who are supposed to be
humble
about it? Wow.
Let's talk about having humility. I read this morning a Newsweek article from the 1970s. talking about global cooling. And it said the science is clear. It is overwhelming. We are in a major cooling period, and it's going to cause enormous problems worldwide. And the solution for all the advocates in the 70s of global cooling was massive government control of the energy sector, of our economy, and aspects of our lives. Now, the data
proved to be... What he didn't say is in that same article, scientists said to dump soot on the polar ice cap to make the ice black to absorb more heat so the ice cap would melt.
Jeez.
Can you imagine if we would have done that?
Amazing.
Not backing up that theory. So then all the advocates of global cooling suddenly shifted to global warming. Mm-hmm. And they advocated it's warming. And the solution, interestingly enough, was the exact same solution, government control of the energy sector and every aspect of our lives. But then the data don't back that up. So if you notice, the term has shifted. And now suddenly it's climate change. And climate change, and again, the solution is government control of the energy sector and every aspect of our lives. And when someone keeps proposing the same solution regardless of the problem, you start to think maybe they just like government control of the energy sector and every aspect of our lives. And I am the child of two mathematicians and scientists.
Here it comes.
I believe in following evidence and data. On the global warming alarmists, anyone who actually points to the evidence that disproves their apocalyptical claims, they don't engage in reasoned debate. What do? They scream, "You're a denier." They brand you a heretic. You know, it is... Today, the global warming alarmists are the equivalent of the flat earthers.
How tremendous is this guy?
Uh-oh, Ted, the debate champion is starting to turn the tables. Uh-oh, I can't wait for the presidential debates.
I love that. Yesterday, it was the CBS Morning News anchor asking him about Obamacare. And he did virtually the same thing to him.
Senator, you say that if you're elected, you would repeal the Affordable Care Act. But since it's passed, 16 million people have become insured. So how would you take that away from them?
Well, you know, those numbers don't tell the whole picture. For one thing, the bulk of those numbers are coming from expanded Medicaid. And Medicaid is a program where a lot of the people on Medicaid are not getting health care.
Right.
Medicaid is a system that is already overburdened. And more people are just getting waiting lists and not actually getting health care. Beyond that, remember, 6 million people had their health insurance canceled because of Obamacare. You're not doing someone a favor if you cancel the health insurance they like and then force them to buy new health insurance at higher premiums that covers less. And I can tell you, people are frustrated. You know, 5 years ago, maybe good faith, reasonable minds could have differed on whether Obamacare might have worked. At this point, it is the single largest job killer in this country.
So great.
Uh-oh. Global champion debate captain has just showed up. Uh-oh.
This is why they are doing everything they can to torture him and to smear him and everything else, because everybody knows, the Republicans and the Democrats know, you get this guy in a debate, he's going to win every time. Can you even imagine if he was going up against Hillary Clinton? He'll slice her to ribbons.
He'll crush her.
I will say I'll watch it.
And the great thing is, he's not going to make a stupid remark like other politicians have. You know, somebody comes out and they haven't thought something through.
He's not a loose cannon. Some in the left label him that way, but he's not that way at all. I've never heard him say anything that was outrageous. Mm-hmm. He doesn't call names. He doesn't yell and scream.
He doesn't have to.
He doesn't have to because he's got too many facts.
Yeah, he's too brilliant.
He'll slice you to ribbons just with the
first
facts.
First in his class in Princeton and Harvard. You think of that.
Magna cum laude at both institutions.
First in his class in Princeton and Harvard.
Yeah.
That's not like being first in my class. You know, who else was your classmate? Glenn Beck. Okay, that's not saying a lot. Princeton and Harvard. That's phenomenal. This guy's going to slice them to ribbons.
I can't wait to see it.
Oh, it's going to be so satisfying.
And he'll start on our side, on the Republican side, anyway, of the ledger, and he'll slice people like Jeb Bush to pieces.
Yes,
Jeb Bush won't stand a chance against this guy.
No.
And you know, if Lindsey Graham gets into it, these people don't want none of this. He don't want a piece of Ted Cruz. I suggest they all stay out of the race right now. Just stay out.
Oh, no, no, no. We'd miss too much fun.
That's probably true. It will be. It'll be entertaining. Because when was the last time we had a candidate we really loved? And he was great debating. He was great
in front
of a hostile
media. No, we've had candidates
we really
loved. For instance, Reagan, we really loved. He used to scare the crap out of me in debates.
Yeah, you never knew what was going to happen.
Because when he would go, he was like Bush and all of them. Yeah, when he'd go, you'd be like, oh, no. Focus, Ron, focus.
Yeah.
You know, he was good at the beginning, but by the end, it was like, I need a, do I have
got
a,
new pants today?
I have a slice of pizza in my pocket. They're like, oh man, they're in trouble.
Is that water?
Yeah, and then we went from that to George W. Bush, George H. W. Bush.
Yeah,
who was kind of the
fool
same.
Fool me once, shame on us. Fool me twice. So you're once, twice, three times a lady, and so I love you.
Everybody we have had since I've been aware. I mean, before Reagan, it was Jerry Ford, and I don't remember the debates with Nixon, but I remember briefly Jerry Ford just being incompetent.
Yeah, well, and I think a lot of that came from Chevy Chase. Don't you? Because of the pratfalls that he took?
Yes, but I don't think that it was too far off. He wasn't that. I mean, he was beaten by Jimmy Carter.
Yes, he was.
Okay.
Yes, he was. That's not a good sign.
Yeah, so. And then we went to Reagan, who was good. Remember his first debate? He lost his first debate against Jimmy Carter.
Yeah.
Badly. Yeah. Badly. And George H.W. Bush wasn't very much better. And then George W. Bush was horrible. John McCain, you remember watching John McCain? He was like,
well, what I would do is socialize everything.
Oh, dear God. And then Mitt Romney,
you know, I agree with you, Mr. President, on...
After the first debate.
Pretty much everything.
The first debate, he was great.
Brilliant, the first one.
Great. And then all of a sudden, he was just... I don't know. It's like... I don't know what happened.
Grover Norquist got a hold of him.
The same thing.
He went off stage and Grover was there.
It's like,
Super Grover!
All right, our sponsor this half hour is Goldline, 1-866-GOLDLINE or goldline.com. I want to tell you that, you know, when you print money, we were talking about a Nobel laureate that escaped Germany in 1928. Escaped Germany in 1928. Why were you escaping Germany in 1928? Because sometimes people can see the handwriting on the walls. 1928, Hitler's not in power yet. It's the Weimar Republic. He gets out because they're printing money. He sees the handwriting on the wall. He sees what's coming. I read a diary of a woman in Germany in the Weimar Republic. And she says, a month ago, none of us knew what hyperinflation meant. Now it's the only thing anyone is talking about. In 30 days, when it begins to happen, it just happens. China has already is. This is a quote from the Chinese. They are de-dollarizing the world. What does that mean? When we get to a certain point and all the countries are in on it, and they'll say, and England, Italy, Germany, China, Australia, India, off the top of my head, Saudi Arabia are now part of this de-dollarization that China is doing. When they de-dollarize the world, that means everybody is just going to say, okay, everybody, out of the dollar. When they release those dollars, all of the dollars that we have printed come flooding back. The inflation is so outrageous, you won't be able to afford anything. Our money will be worthless. Remember, this just happened in Iceland. You couldn't afford a hamburger at McDonald's. McDonald's closed their doors because they couldn't buy the beef for their hamburgers. And I don't think there's a lot of beef in those things. Go to Goldline. Gold or silver. Not right for everybody. It sure is for me. Do your own homework. 1-866-GOLDLINE or goldline.com.
You're listening to the Glenn Beck Program.
The Blaze Radio Network.
The
This is Texas Superfood Jingle, take number one.
Texas Superfood. Well, it's a big old honk of country food.
What was that?
Isn't it some big old country food?
No, it's made with 55 different fruits and vegetables picked at their peak of ripeness, and then they add nothing.
Didn't realize.
Okay, take two.
At starttexassuperfood.com.
So good, you'll be able to fly.
What was that?
It's Texas Superfood.
No, super as in a super healthy serving of fruits and vegetables. No superpowers, just everything you need to start a healthier life.
Oh.
Here we go, take three.
Vegetasia.
No, take 12.
Now powered with unicorn tears.
No. Okay, look, just say, Texas Superfood, honest-to-goodness nutrition you can trust.
Honest-to-goodness nutrition you can trust.
Great.
Made by a real wizard.
Nope.
Visit StartTexasSuperfood.com today or call us at 844-55-FRESH.
Johnny, what are you doing in the bathroom? What are you saying? Wait, where are your toy cars? Oh, no, tell me you didn't. Honey, call Mike Scott Plumbing.
I didn't do anything.
For once, that's true, but little Johnny flushed his toys down the toilet, and now it's broke.
Yes. I mean, oh no. I'll get the phone. What's the toll-free number?
866-314-4443.
Got it. 866-314-4443.
Mike Scott Plumbing. If water runs through it, they do it. At Mike Scott Plumbing, from the moment you walk through the doors, it's evident that quality is key. From our fully stocked parts department to our fully trained service technicians who can help with anything from a clogged drain to your irrigation system and even servicing your entire septic system. Visit one of our beautiful showrooms in Hernando or in Wildwood and let us show you how to turn your kitchen and bath dreams into reality. Mike Scott Plumbing. If water runs through it, we do it.
Hi, this is JP from Penn Flooring here in Ocala. I would like to invite you to come in and visit our spacious showroom where we have solutions for every style and budget. From wall-to-wall carpet to hardwood floors and tiles, we have an unsurpassed selection of flooring. At Penn Flooring, we've provided quality customer service with a family touch for over 25 years. Visit our website at pennflooring.com or come by our showroom, 1201 Southwest 17th Street, just over the bridge. Penn Flooring, quality customer service with a family touch.
My name is Erica Olstein. I'm a doctor of acupuncture and oriental medicine at A Better You Healthcare's Pokin for the People Community Acupuncture. Join us every Monday at 4 p.m. for a relaxing and therapeutic community acupuncture session with like-minded, health-conscious individuals from our community. Pricing is only $35. Group sessions involve yoga breathing and acupuncture for the benefit of stress, anxiety, and depression. Unwind and start your week off right. If stress is leaving you a mess, you need a checkup from the neck up. When you're feeling blue, come to A Better You. A Better You Healthcare, just behind the Paddock Mall on 27th Avenue. For further details, visit abetteryouhealthcare.com or call 615-5566. Again, that number is 615-5566.
Here's what you may have missed on the John Tesh Radio Show.
In a study involving more than 2,000 people, those with slimmer waistlines showed higher cognitive ability than those who were overweight or obese. Our pets improve our character and make us much better people. If your partner's the one who's stressed out, we know that you will be 25% more likely to be affected than a stranger would be. Yeah, be careful because stress is contagious.
Intelligence for your life on the John Tesh Radio Show. Don't miss this stuff.
Glenn Beck.
So Grover Norquist at 5 o'clock. I don't want you to miss that episode. It is free. If you go to theblaze.com/Grover and you watch that at 5 o'clock tonight, you don't want to miss that. I don't know. I mean, I'm not trying to get a win out of this. I'm just trying to get some answers. I don't think that there's going to be a gotcha moment on this. I hope that it's just a good, reasonable conversation about how these things could possibly happen. Again, not trying to get a gotcha, but
trying to get some answers because none of these things make any sense to me.
It's just outreach, Glenn. That's all it is. I'm just reaching out to, aren't you the guy who says strange bedfellows?
Yeah, not that strange. Not ones that like suicide vests.
No.
That's a little too strange.
You're listening to the Glenn Beck Program.
The Blaze Radio Network.
More and more of our listeners have found out about the secret we've been talking about, Shave Secret, the shaving oil that reduces nicks, cuts, and shaving rashes. Shave Secret conditions and moisturizes in one application, making your skin feel smooth and soft. Shave Secret, it's a compact size that makes perfect for traveling. And here's a couple of listeners that have written in and told us, John said, a shave for the very first time with Shave Secret was effortless, painless, and incredibly smooth during and after. Dave wrote in, I've been shaving for 20 years. I've tried gels, foam, shaving soaps, and even shaving oils. This is the best stuff I've ever used. And Ginger in Wisconsin writes, this stuff is amazing. My son used to get an awful lot of bumps when he shaved, and now it doesn't happen with just a couple of drops of this wonderful oil. Shave Secret, good for men and women and all ethnic groups. Parents and grandparents are passing on the advice to their children to start out shaving right with Shave Secret. Shave Secret, for the best shave ever. Buy some today at ShaveSecret.com or at Walmart Supercenter.
Last weekend, we released the final new dockable waterfront acreage on the Texas coastline with easy access from Houston. The response was so incredible, we are now 90% sold out. We have under 10 home sites available, half waterfront and half Bayview. In order to sell them quickly, we are going to hold over the $10,000 to $20,000 in savings. With these savings, you can own a brand new coastal cottage for only $79.9 or 7.2 acres with Bayviews and water access for just $59.9. Call 844-200. Land. This area offers a relaxing coastal lifestyle in a renowned fishing area. Each property has underground utilities, clear title, excellent financing, including special financing for Texas veterans. Save $10,000 to $20,000 for a limited time while inventory remains. Now's the ideal time. Purchase your coastal retreat before the heat. Call for directions. 844-200-LAND. That's 844-200-LAND. 844-200-5263. Cottage shell lot not included.
Hey, I'm Gary.
And I'm Eric. Did you know that Red Eye Radio is on WOCA The Source every night from 2 to 6 a.m. and it's live?
That's right. No tape shows here.
We know that the news doesn't sleep.
And neither do we. So we're here with you live from 2 till 6 a.m. every weekday. Call us 866-90-RED-EYE. So join me, Gary McNamara.
And me, Eric Harley, every weeknight to discuss the latest in news and entertainment.
Right here on WOCA The Source.
Hey, Matt, I know Sunrise Automotive does auto stuff, but I need some tires for my truck. Can you recommend someone?
Yes, I can. We do that.
No, I mean, I need them installed and balanced and all that.
Yep, yep, we do that.
Well, my son needed his windows tinted.
Yep, we do that.
I need my seat replaced.
Yep, yep, we do that too.
I need a new roofline, and a new spoiler, and a new
truck.
Yep,
we can even do that too.
Okay, okay, I get it. I suppose you can also do a radio show too, huh?
Well, as a matter of fact, join me every Monday at 10 for auto repair with personal care here on The Source.
Of course you do.
Broadcasting from the Paddock Mall Studios, this is WOCA, Ocala, Gainesville, The Villages, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, The Source.
Fox News Radio, I'm Lillian Wu. Revelations from the cockpit recorder of the doomed German Wings flight only raising more questions, such as why the co-pilot apparently crashed the passenger plane.
28-year-old German Andreas Lubitz passed every test and check during pilot training, according to his employers. Carsten Spohr, the head of Lufthansa, saying Lubitz's actions have left us speechless.
Fox Radio, Simon Owen. Lubitz apparently locked the pilot out of the cockpit and alarm was set off with the pilot desperately trying to get back in.
On the recording, you only hear the screams literally on the last moments of the recording.
Voice of the translator for Marseille prosecutor Bryce Robin. Suburban Chicago cousins have been arrested in an Islamic State case, according to the U.S. Attorney's Office, one of them a member of the Illinois Army National Guard. Fox News, we report you this side.
I'm Lex Friedman. I run my own business, so I know from experience, hiring new employees can be tough. Posting your job in one place isn't enough to find quality candidates. If you want to find the perfect hire,